Hello, good afternoon, and welcome to Henley High School for the first round of the OSAA On Point Community Credit Union 4A Girls Basketball Playoffs as the number 2 seed Hornets host the number 15 seed St. Helens Lions. Alongside Josh Eldridge, I'm Matt Bowling. It is a frosty Saturday here in Klamath Falls, but it's nice and warm in the gym as Henley looking to advance to their second straight state quarterfinals. Meanwhile, St. Helens looking to pull off a massive upset in their first playoff appearance since 1997. We'll have more on both of these teams and how they got here on the other side of this break. Alongside Josh Eldridge again, I'm Matt Bowling. You're watching Henley Basketball on MyBasin.com and listening on 104.3 and 960 Sports.
Wait, all I do is wait. So lonely, I just sigh and mourn. Seems like I've been waiting forever. Wondering if you're coming home.
I just saw your face.
This is where unconditional love and immeasurable happiness reside. This is home. Coldwell Banker, where home begins.
Introducing State's Marcom Solutions, your trusted partner in marketing and communication. We specialize in crafting compelling campaigns, eye-catching graphics, and impactful branding materials.
Smith Bates is like working with dependable friends. They always help us build our professional image.
Through the innovative strategies that the team at Smith Bates suggested, we've been able to give the brand at Calor the boost that it desperately needed.
Unlock your potential with Smith Bates Marcom Solutions.
Back with you here at Henley High School, just about a little under 6 minutes away from tip-off here between the number 2 seed Henley Hornets and number 15 seed St. Helens Lions. Look at Henley, it's looking a lot like 2015 for the Hornets. That's the last year they were the number 2 seed in the playoffs. It's also the last year they won 20 games. They were 22-1 entering the playoffs last year, that year. This year they're 20-2. Their only losses are to number 4 seed Cascade and number 5 seed Klamath Union. Henley lost the state title game that year in 2015. They'll be hoping for a better ending this time, but it all starts with getting a win today, Josh.
Yeah, they got to feel confident coming into a game against St. Helens, who, you know, they finished sub-500 out of a very difficult league, so it's kind of difficult to gauge how really good this St. Helens team is. They played a tough schedule, and they made a long trip out here, but the Hornets still have got to feel confident coming into a game against a team that they certainly feel better than.
Yeah, 4 of the 5 teams in St. Helens League, the Kauapaw League, I don't know if I pronounced that right, but they were ranked in the top 16 and earned postseason bids. They had the number 1 seed Astoria, number 10 seed Seaside, also had Scappoose, which got a play-in berth. This team is battle-tested. They have a couple good wins to show for it. They won at Seaside 46-41 on February 6th, and they beat North Bend, which was 16-9 in the play-in game. Now, there's a lot of missing data on the St. Helens girls basketball program prior to 2005. What we can tell you is that the Lions are 12-13 this season. It's only the second time since 2004 they've won that many games. We also said it's the first time they've made the playoffs since 1997. This is their second season as a 4A school. They were moved down from 5A at the end of the 2021-22 school year after many years in that classification. Girls basketball, at least, didn't get any easier for them, but they made it through a gauntlet, and they are here in the postseason trying to book their first state tournament appearance in we don't even know how long.
And they're led by underclassmen, too, which is a little bit different than what you normally see for teams making their first trip to the playoffs. A handful of girls who haven't played on this big of a stage before. Meantime, Henley, I mean, they made the Elite Eight last year, and they were able to make it to the final day of the tournament. So another key difference there. St. Helens hasn't been here before, so the first trip for them.
Yeah, you touched on the lineups a little bit. We'll get deeper into those on the other side of this break. Just a few minutes away from lineups, introductions, and tip-off here on MyBasin.com and 104.3 and 960 Sports.
Comfortable and not corporate. At Clownfall Subaru, we built our business on that simple promise. Well, that and some of the best people you're ever going to meet. Hi, I'm Rob Cedar, General Manager at Clownfall Subaru. Our 62 employees make it easy for us to live up to our comfortable, not corporate philosophy. Friendly faces, easy answers, straight talk, fairness, and exceptional service. These are the things you expect. These are the things that all of our people deliver. Our management team, sales pros, certified service and body shop techs, lot attendants, and detail experts are all 100% focused on you, local people putting their friends and neighbors first. At Clownfall Subaru, that's the only way we do business. It's comfortable, not corporate. Our team members also spend hundreds of hours each year supporting local charities and events through the Subaru Love Promise. That's the kind of people they are. We're very proud of them. They're your friends, they're your neighbors, they're glad to know you, and they want you to be glad to know them too. I'm Rob, and this is what makes us comfortable, not corporate.
What comes with great?
Participate.
Where does greatness start? Here, in the classroom. On the stage.
In the pool. On the field.
Where will your greatness take you?
To better grades.
To more friends.
Yeah!
Be great.
Participate! Yeah.
There are many threads that run through our region. There are churches and schools and little league teams that bring us together and bind us into communities. There are roads and cars. There are houses and jobs and businesses, all woven together to make the fabric of our communities. There are financial threads that are part of that tapestry as well. For over 80 years, it's been our pleasure to be headquartered here, providing financial services to generations of our friends and neighbors. From that first savings account to retirement planning and all of the cars and houses and groceries in between, we keep your money local, investing it back into our communities, adding more threads to the fabric to make our community stronger. Pacific Crest Federal Credit Union. Find your path.
back with you here at Henley High School as we are just about ready for the introduction of the starting lineups. Number 2 seed Hornets and number 15 seed St. Helens here in the first round of the OSA playoffs. Matt Bowling here with you alongside Josh Eldridge. Gone through the full out for the national anthem. Special appearance from the Henley color guard. So let's take a look at the starting lineups. First for Henley. Well, looking at both of these lineups, you notice there's a pretty good balance of youth and experience. St. Helens with 2 seniors, 1 junior, and 2 sophomores. Henley with 2 seniors, 1 junior, 1 sophomore, and 1 freshman. For the Hornets, it's the usual suspects, at least for the first part of the season. Preston Shade, Lily Fassell, Annie Campos, Anna Harper, only in her second game back from a month-long absence, rounded out with Jewel Northcutt. For St. Helens, it's Devin Lee, Kayla Duick, Maisie McDowell, D.A. Davidson, and McKenna Harden. Now, we mentioned 2 sophomores there in the starting lineup for the Lions. Those are the 2 leading scorers. Devin Lee averaging 12.3 points per game. She was honorable mention All-State as a freshman last year. And D.A. Davidson averaging 11.2 points per game. They're going to need everything they can get from those two if they're going to compete with this stacked Henley lineup, though, Josh.
And a senior-led team at that for the Hornets. This team's got experience, and you said it. This team can score, they can defend, they can do everything. That's why they're the number 2 seed.
And you look at Preston Shade, freshman there in the lineup. Through league play, she was averaging 6.4 points, 4 rebounds, 3 steals, and 2.4 assists. She had a 2.7 assist to turnover ratio. That is a really good number for a freshman. Annie Campos averaging 12.1 points, 6.1 rebounds, 5.1 steals, and 3.9 assists with a 2.8 assist to turnover ratio. Anna Harper, as we mentioned, she was out for about a month after the first league game. She had been averaging 14.6 points per game. She came back for the regular season finale against Phoenix, 8 points and 8 rebounds. St. Helens wins the tip-off, and we're underway. They go to the top of the key with Devin Lee. She tries to throw it down low. It's almost turned over, but recovered and put up by Davidson. The shot won't fall. It's rebounded by Anna Harper, who brings it back up. Over to Lily Fassell on the left wing. She tries to dribble in, has it poked away from her, gets it back. Into Harper, turnaround shot. And Anna Harper has the first points of the game. It's 2-0 Henley, 7:25 left in the first quarter. Just a quick turnaround shot in the paint. And St. Helens trying to answer the other way with McDowell, but her shot wouldn't fall. Annie Campos with the ball in her hands for the first time today. Goes up in the right lane and draws a foul. It's on D.A. Davidson. That's her first. .709 to go in the first quarter. Annie Campos makes the first free throw. And the second. 4-0 Henley. Devin Lee looking to inbound. Lee trying to go coast to coast with it, and does. Getting it back off the inbound and cutting Henley's lead to 4-2 with 6:56 to go in the first, but we've got another foul called against the Lions. on Maisie McDowell, her first, second on St. Helens. Preston Shade to inbound on the right wing. Throws it to Anna Harper near midcourt. She gives it to Annie Campos at the top of the key. Campos moving left. In the corner, Harper driving baseline through two defenders, gets it up. It won't fall. Rebound batted around. She has it wrestled away from her, but a foul is called. That one's going to be on Harper. Lee inbounding to Davidson. Up to McDowell. McDowell on the right side has it ripped away from her by Annie Campos. She just came out of nowhere for that steal. Now she's trying to take it back for two, and does. Four early points for Annie Campos, and Henley has a 6-2 lead with 6:15 to go in the first. Ball almost lost out of bounds by Duick. She gets it back, guarded tightly by Northcutt. Davidson on the right elbow with it. Davidson trying to drive on Annie Campos. Puts a shot up, and it's off the front of the rim. Just suffocating defense there by Annie Campos, who then throws an outlet pass to Anna Harper for the bucket. Timeout St. Helens. Henley's up 8-2 with 5:49 to go in the first quarter. We'll be right back.
Thanks to Les Schwab Tires, I'm a confident backseat driver, but mom's a little stressed about spending. Remember, deep breaths and watch your speed. Even though we're watching our wallets, Les Schwab is still watching out for our safety. So it's right here.
During the Les Schwab Founders Celebration Sale, save up to $150 instantly on select sets of four tires. Les Schwab Tires, doing the right thing since 1952.
Back underway out of the timeout here at Henley as the Hornets have gone up 8-2 with 5:40 to go in the first quarter. At the top of the key with it for St. Helens is McDowell. McDowell give and go results in a loose ball down in the paint, and it's a tie-up. Harper throws it in to Annie Campos. Harper drives, gets fouled. That's already the third team foul on St. Helens. Two more, and Henley will be in the bonus for the rest of the quarter. 5:21 on the clock. And perhaps even more importantly, it's the second foul on D.A. Davidson. So she'll have to come to the bench as they throw it into Annie Campos. Campos driving through the left lane, sends it off the side of the backboard, gets her own miss, and gets the putback. Annie Campos is not messing around today. She's got 6 points, not even 3 minutes into the first quarter. 10-2 lead for Henley. But Annie Campos gets whistled for a reach-in foul on the other end. That's her first, second on Henley. 4:57 to go in the first quarter. Senya Campos is checking in for Lily Fussell. I think that's Henley's first substitution of the day. Inbound to McDowell. Up top, Duick. Pass into the corner, tipped out. It was intended for Devin Lee. Duick to inbound, throws it up to Lee. Lee trying to drive on Annie Campos at the right elbow. Back out to Harden. Corner three for Maddie Hancock is too long. It goes out of bounds. And I'll say it was off of Kennedy Modine. 15 seconds on the shot clock. Duick to inbound on the left side. Gets it to Lee, who immediately pulls up misses the three off the back of the rim. Duick gets the rebound, though. Another possession for the Lions. Down low is Hancock. Tight defense results in a tie-up. Possession arrow favors the Lions. Still a 10-2 lead for Henley. 4:27 to go in the first quarter. Duick trying to inbound around Kennedy Modine. Able to get it to Hancock. Hancock in the left corner. Fouled on the left wing. Anna Harper, bit aggressive there. That's a hallmark of this Henley defense. They are so aggressive. Sometimes it gets them in foul trouble, though. As Anna Harper picks up her second and will come to the bench. Foul count is now even at three apiece this quarter. Into the left corner, McDowell throwing it to Hancock on the left block. Back out to McDowell, whose three is off the mark. Rebound and the putback, though, is there for Maddie Hancock. 10-4 Henley leads, 4:06 left in the first quarter. Annie Campos pulls a three immediately on the other end and knocks it down. She has nine, and Henley has a 13-4 lead with 3:51 to go as St. Helens misses on the other end. Loose ball on the floor, though. And a foul called. McKenna Harden was on the floor trying to get the ball up, and well, I'm not sure exactly what she might have done to draw that foul. Maybe swung her elbows a little too much. It's the fourth on St. Helens. Astoria is who the Henley boys will be playing right after this. Maya Mox missed shot, results in a loose ball and a foul called against Henley. 4-4. The foul count with 3:33 left in the first quarter. Next foul for either team will be free throws. It's the first on Mock. 3:30 left in the first quarter. Henley still up 13-4. As the pass tipped out of bounds at midcourt by Maya Mock, it'll stay with the Lions. Kayla Duick throws it into Devin Lee. Lee throws it to Michael. Left wing, back up top, Hancock. Pass stolen by Kennedy Modine. And a walk-in layup for her on the other end. 15-4. Henley leads with 3:08 to go in the first. They tried to throw it onto the right wing, but Modine read it the whole way. That pass almost intercepted again. It's tipped out into the backcourt from the top of the key, recovered by McKenna Harden. Harden defended tightly by Northcutt. Throws it over to Duick. Duick near midcourt. Between the circles, hands it to Devin Lee. 7 seconds on the shot clock. Lee has to get something going. She throws it up from just inside the arc. It won't go. Senya Campos fighting for the rebound, but it goes out of bounds. It'll stay with St. Helens. Lily Fassell checks in for Jewel Northcutt. As Devin Lee gets set to inbound from the left side of the baseline. 2:31 to go in the first quarter. Michael dribbling around the perimeter. Throws it to Devin Lee on the right side. Lee dribbling up near the center circle. Now she'll drive. At the left elbow, throws it down low to Michael. Her shot wouldn't fall. And a foul on the rebound. Free throws coming for Henley. 2:13 to go in the first quarter. It's on Maddie Hancock. That's her first. And it'll send Lily Fassell to the line.
Henley's done a good job of taking care of the basketball in this first half. It's one of the things that you'd mentioned they're so good at. I mean, their guards are averaging over, you know, two assists per turnover. So far, Henley hasn't turned the ball over once.
Fassell misses her first free throw. As Maisie McDowell checks back in for St. Helens. Second free throw is good for Lily Fassell, so it's 16-4 Henley with 2:13 left in the first quarter. Hancock picked up at full court by Annie Campos. They get it across. Devin Lee on the left side. Lee, step back, swish. Nice move by Devin Lee to create some space between her and Maya Mock. And Annie Campos tried to answer with a three on the other end. Rebound was tipped to Kennedy Modine. Now back up to Lily Fussell. She dribbles in, pulls a left elbow jumper that takes a bounce off the rim and goes in. 18-7, Henley leads. 1:37 left in the second, in the first quarter. Dole throwing it to Bella Michael. Michael trying to dribble in from the left side. At the top of the key, McDole. McDole driving through the right lane, and she's fouled. Maisie McDole going to be looking for her first points of the game here with these free throws. Now, most St. Helens players are a long way from home today. That was about a 7 or 8 hour bus trip they took from near the Oregon-Washington border. But Maisie McDowell's only a short drive from her new home. She'll be attending Oregon Tech next year. Getting a nice taste of winter here in Klamath Falls today.
It's just in time.
She makes both free throws. So St. Helens cuts it to 18-9 with a minute 15 left in the first quarter. Preston Shade fouled on the drive through the right lane. Dribbling it in from the left wing. Preston Shade, a freshman. Her athletic career at Henley is already off to a great start. She won a league championship with the girls' soccer team in the fall and has won one here with Henley with the girls' basketball team in the winter. She goes 2 for 2 from the free throw line, so it's a 29 lead for the Hornets, a minute 10 left in the first quarter. Inbound by the Lions is tipped out at their bench. It'll stay with them. Maisie McDowell looking to throw it in. Finds Maddie Hancock. Hancock gets it across midcourt to McDowell. Down to Bella Michael, dribbling it along the left wing. Lee taking it in from the left elbow through traffic, gets it to fall. Devin Lee has 6 of St. Helens' 11 points so far. Annie Campos can't answer with a 3 on the other end. Bailey Ladner grabs the rebound. Preston Shade in the right corner. Bounces it to Northcutt. She's fouled. 32 seconds even here in the first quarter. Henley up 20-11, looking to get the lead back to double digits at the free throw line. Northcutt misses the first one. Misses the second one. Rebound is loose. Northcutt had it for a second. It was tipped to Annie Campos, who fires a shot off the glass that won't go. Bailey Ladner is fouled on the putback attempt. So another trip to the line for the Hornets. Fouls on Chloe Claughton. That's her first. 24.9 seconds left in the first quarter. Bailey Ladner makes her first free throw. Averaged 4.8 points, 4.3 rebounds, and 1.6 steals in league play. Missed her second free throw. It's a 21-11 lead for Henley with 20 seconds left in the first quarter. Michael. Devin Lee on the left wing. 9 seconds to go. Lee tries to drive, throws it up, but traveled first. That was a tough shot if it would have counted. Threw it up through multiple defenders. Got it to bank in off the glass. 4 seconds to go. Annie Campos driving in the paint, loses it on the shot. She was trying the finger roll, but it kind of slipped out of her hands. It's still Henley ball. Say somebody touched it. 1.2 seconds. Quick inbound to Annie Campos, who pulls it up. Bang. A fitting end to the first quarter for Annie Campos. She has 11 points, and Henley has a 23-11 lead heading into the second. We'll be right back. Matt Bowling here alongside Josh Eldridge. It's Henley basketball on MyBasin.com and 104.3 and 960 Sports.
There are many threads that run through our region. There are churches and schools and little league teams that bring us together and bind us into communities. There are roads and cars. There are houses and jobs and businesses, all woven together to make the fabric of our communities. There are financial threads that are part of that tapestry as well. For over 80 years, it's been our pleasure to be headquartered here, providing financial services to generations of our friends and neighbors. From that first savings account, to retirement planning, and all of the cars and houses and groceries in between, we keep your money local, investing it back into our communities, adding more threads to the fabric to make our community stronger. Pacific Crest Federal Credit Union. Find your path.
Second quarter, as Jewel Northcutt draws a foul, dribbling in from the right side for a shot. And she'll head to the line. It's on D.A. Davidson. That is her third. 7:48 left in the second. Northcutt makes the first free throw. As we mentioned, D.A. Davidson, second leading scorer for St. Helens. She's averaging 11.2 points per game. She's been held off the board so far and will now have to sit for what I assume will be the remainder of the half, as Jewel Northcutt knocks down both free throws to put Henley up 25-11. And there's a steal at midcourt by Fassell. She hesitates, fakes out the defender, and banks it in from the left elbow, or left block, rather. A 16-point lead for Henley as Fassell comes right back and tips a pass out of bounds in the front court. Henley up 27-11, 7:24 to go in the second quarter. McDowell throws it in to Devin Lee. She's got six of her team's 11. She loses the ball. It's picked up by Jewel Northcutt. Northcutt trying to take it the distance, and she gets called for the charge as she kind of elbowed Devin Lee off of her. That's her first, and it evens the foul count at one apiece here in the second quarter. 7:12 to go. Henley still up 27-11. Inbound to Duick. Over to McDowell. McDowell dribbles it across half court on the right side. Lee dribbling into the paint, surrounded by defenders. Devin Lee throws up a desperation shot that won't fall. Shade grabs the rebound. Shade trying to go coast to coast, sends it off the bottom of the rim, but is fouled. Almost runs into the HSPN table there at the front row of the student section.
Kids are all business. That was the theme today for the Henley student section, strictly business. They've got kids with ties and jackets and the whole nine over there. They're looking good, looking stylish. And then I think someone's wearing swim trunks over there. I don't know if that exactly fits the bill, but the student section always in style.
Shade misses the first free throw, but makes the second. It's 28-11, Henley. And St. Helens turns it over. And we've got a timeout. 6:46 to go in the second. Henley with a 17-point lead. We'll be right back.
What rhymes with great?
Participate.
Where does greatness start? Here, in the classroom. On the stage.
In the pool.
On the field.
Where will your greatness take you?
To better grades.
To more friends.
Yeah!
Be great.
Participate!
Back with you here at Henley on MyBasin.com and 104.3 and 960 Sports. Matt Bowling here alongside Josh Eldridge. Henley girls, the number two seed here in the OSA On Point Community Credit Union 4A playoffs, are dominating number 15 seed St. Helens so far. Annie Campos just muscles her way through two defenders and gets it to go off the glass. It's 30-11 Henley, 6:32 to go in the second quarter. Annie Campos is outscoring the Lions by herself. She's got 13. She stands rock solid there as Devin Lee tried to draw the foul, throwing the shot up. It wouldn't go. She didn't get the call either. Preston Shade loses it on the other end. Here comes Lee trying to go coast to coast. Runs into Campos again, and that time Annie is called for the blocking foul. That's her second. It's the third of the quarter on Henley. The foul count is now 3-2 in favor of the Lions. Sends Devin Lee to the free throw line. She had six in the first quarter, and she makes her first one here. Senya Campos, Maya Mock, and Kennedy Modine check in for Bailey Ladner, Lily Fassell, and Jewel Northcutt as Devin Lee gets set for her second free throw. It rattles in off the front and back of the rim. So Henley now up 30-13 with 6:07 to go in the second quarter as Kennedy Modine gets called for the travel, trying to take it in from the right wing. Maisie McDowell to inbound for the Lions. Throws it into Lee. She's picked up full court by Maya Mock. Mock fouls her as Lee took it to the right elbow. That's the second on Mock. Fourth of the quarter on Henley. Or I guess it's the third. Scoreboard still says third. Whistle on the inbound. They might have said Senya Campos didn't give her enough room. They get it in this time. It's Lee with it on the right wing, and she loses it. It's a tie-up. Senya Campos getting her hands in there to force the held ball. Possession arrow favors St. Helens. McDowell to inbound. Guarded again by Senya Campos. Gets it into Lee. Lee slips past Maya Mock, throws it to Harden. Left wing jumper is good. It's a long two. Makes it 30-15. Henley on top. 5:43 to go in the second quarter. Annie Campos answers immediately on the other end with a drive through the right lane. 32-15 lead for the Hornets. 5:38 to go in the second. Kayla Duick checks out for St. Helens. She's replaced by Bella Michael. Maisie McDowell to inbound. Throws it up to Hancock. She hands it to Lee. Lee, underhand throw to Harden on the baseline. She was unable to keep it in bounds. And it's another St. Helens turnover. Lily Fassell back in, replacing Anna Harper. 5:33 to go in the second quarter. Henley up 32-15. Annie Campos pulls a three, no good, off the back of the rim. Rebound goes out of bounds. It'll be Lions ball. Devin Lee bringing it across half court, guarded by Modine. Lee, tight defense by Modine. She spins away from her, throws it up, and one. That is a tough shot by Devin Lee, spinning into the high post and throwing up a floater through contact.
You haven't seen very many players be able to do that to Henley's defense, kind of penetrate by herself and battle through contact. She's done it a couple of times. This is the first time she's gotten the whistle, but she's trying to get this team back into the game.
She misses the free throw. So it's 32-17 Henley, 5:02 to go in the second quarter. Shade up top. Campos, right wing, fouled as she went around McKenna Harden. That's McKenna Harden's third foul. It's the third of the quarter on St. Helens. Foul count is 4-3 in favor of the Lions. Senya Campos' pass underneath is intercepted by Lee. Lee at the top of the key. Hands it to McDowell. McDowell trying to drive. Kicks it out to Duick, who misses a right wing three. Rebound loose underneath, picked up by Lily Fassell. Fassell driving up the left side. Throws it to Shade at the top of the key. Shade driving through the right lane, kicks it back out to Fassell, who pulls a three, misses off the front of the rim. Maisie McDowell grabs the rebound. Thrown to Lee. Lee on the left side. Out to Duick, left wing. Now to Michael on the right side. 20 seconds on the shot clock. Devin Lee driving through the right lane. Floater rolls in. Tell you what, you're seeing why Devin Lee was honorable mention All-State last year as a freshman. Oh, my goodness.
Talk about a freshman making a move.
Yeah, there's a freshman for you. Preston Shade breaking Maddie Hancock's ankles for the bucket. It's a 34-19 lead for Henley. 3:35 to go in the second quarter. Hancock trying to get it back on the other end, draws a foul. That was a filthy move by Preston Shade down on the right block. Hancock misses the first free throw. Three subs in for Henley. It's Annie Campos, Anna Harper, and Jewel Northcutt on for Senya Campos, Lily Fassell, and Maya Mock. Hancock makes the second free throw, so it's a 34-20 lead for Henley, 3:28 to go in the second. Campos driving through the right lane gets fouled.
Been a lot of fouls called in this game. I mean, obviously you can tell that by looking at the count, right? Henley's at five team fouls, St. Helens at four, but it's only been a quarter and a half of play in 35 real minutes. This game has slowed down a lot.
Annie Campos misses the first free throw. The foul was on Devin Lee. That's her second. Campos goes 0 for 2 from the line, gets her own miss, turns around, puts it up, and after several bounces, it goes in. Devin Lee the other way, floater, swish. Nice shot from between the elbow and the block. 36-22. Henley still up, 3:02 to go in the second quarter. Maisie McDowell called for the foul on the other end. It will send Kennedy Modine to the free throw line. Second foul on McDowell. 3:02 to go in the second quarter. Modine with 2 points so far, misses her first free throw. Second one is good, so it's a 15-point lead for Henley. Lee picked up at full court. Pass tipped by Annie Campos. Stolen by Jewel Northcutt, who gets ran into by Maisie McDowell. So it'll be free throws for Northcutt. Man, talk about a tough sequence there for St. Helens. You have a pass get tipped. Northcutt recovers it. Then gets run into by McDowell, who was trying to contest for it. And with Henley being in the bonus, that's two free throws for Jewel Northcutt. It's the third foul on McDowell. Northcutt goes 1-for-2 from the line, but Anna Harper gets the rebound on the missed second free throw, pulls up a three. That won't go. Annie Campos tried the putback, but got fouled. More free throws for the Hornets. That one's on Bella Michael. That's her first. Annie Campos gets a very friendly bounce off the back of the rim on the first free throw. I'll tell you one good thing about there being so many fouls called this game, Josh, is that Henley has a chance to work on free throws. It's something they've struggled with at times late in the season. In their last loss against Klamath Union, they were 8 of 24 from the stripe. Annie Campos went 2-for-2 there. So Henley now up 40-22. Well, that could be cut into shortly here as Devin Lee earns a trip to the line off a foul in the paint. 2:37 to go here in the first half. Lee makes the first free throw. She's got 15. Make that 16. 2:37 to go in the second quarter. Campos weaving her way through the defense for the bucket. 42-24 Henley, 2:27 left in the first half. Duick throws it to Lee. Lee has it taken away from her momentarily by Annie Campos, but it comes back down to Caitlin Keith. Keith at the top of the key. Annie Campos went for the steal, got called for the reach in, and Henley does not like that at all. Visceral reaction from the bench. It sure seemed like she got all ball. That's her third foul.
And it leads to free throws, too.
Caitlin Keefe, one of the four seniors on this St. Helens roster, makes her first free throw. Annie Campos and Jewel Northcutt check out for Lily Fassell and Maya Mock. 2:06 remaining here in the second quarter. Keefe misses the second free throw. Harper grabs the rebound. Hornets up 42-25. 2 minutes left. Modine skips it into Shade. Shade, no good off the glass. Devin Lee at the top of the key for St. Helens. Throws it, dribbling in from the left wing, getting her own miss. Putback won't go. Bella Michael. Modine driving through the right lane. Her shot won't fall. Rebound tipped out all the way to midcourt where it rolls out of bounds. It'll stay with the Hornets. Modine dribbling it up from half court. Hands it to Anna Harper. Harper at the top of the key, now moving toward the right side. Shade dribbling it in from the right elbow. Her shot won't fall off the glass. Kayla Dewitt grabs the rebound. up to Bella Michael on the right wing. 1:04 to go. Bella Michael throwing it to Duick. Left wing. Duick trying to slip past Harper. Throws it to Keefe, who misses a shot from the right side. Rebound tip to Keefe. She sends it out to Duick, who misses a three from the right slot. Another offensive board for St. Helens. Bella Michael tried a shot from right underneath the basket that wouldn't go. Shade trying to go coast to coast. Her runner won't fall. She whips it over to Facel, whose pull-up from the block won't go. She gets her own miss. Turnaround finally drops. 44-25, Henley on top. 20 seconds to go in the first half. Lee trying to go coast to coast with it. It won't fall off the glass. She gets her own miss. Out beyond the arc, pulls up. It won't fall. Underneath, Michael is fouled. St. Helens really giving Henley trouble on the offensive glass over these last few minutes. Bella Michael makes her first free throw. As Senya Campos checks in for Kennedy Modine. Michael getting set for her second free throw. And she makes it. 44-27, 8 seconds left in the first half. Shade throws it to Senya Campos in the right corner. She takes it in, puts it up, and gets fouled. 2.6 on the clock. Senya Campos with a chance at her first points of the game from the free throw line. Her first shot rolls out. Second one rolls out. 2 seconds, only time for a full court heave, and they won't even get it off. Henley heads into halftime with a 44-27 lead here in the 2-15 matchup. First round of the OSAA On Point Community Credit Union 4A Girls Basketball Playoffs. Matt Bowling here alongside Josh Eldridge. We'll have your first half scoring after this break here on MyBasin.com and 104.3 and 960 Sports.
Comfortable and not corporate. At Clownfall Subaru, we built our business on that simple promise. Well, that and some of the best people you're ever going to meet. Hi, I'm Rob Cedar, General Manager at Clownfall Subaru. Our 62 employees make it easy for us to live up to our comfortable, not corporate philosophy. Friendly faces, easy answers, straight talk, fairness, and exceptional service. These are the things you expect. These are the things that all of our people deliver. Our management team, sales pros, certified service and body shop techs, lot attendants, and detail experts are all 100% focused on you. Local people putting their friends and neighbors first. At Clown Falls Subaru, that's the only way we do business. It's comfortable, not corporate. Our team members also spend hundreds of hours each year supporting local charities and events through the Subaru Love Promise. That's the kind of people they are. We're very proud of them. They're your friends, they're your neighbors, they're glad to know you, and they want you to be glad to know them too. I'm Rob, and this is what makes us comfortable, not corporate.
18, 19. Thanks to Les Schwab Tires, I'm a confident backseat driver, but Mom's a little stressed about spending. Remember, deep breaths, and watch your speed. Even though we're watching our wallets, Les Schwab is still watching out for our safety. So turn here.
During the Les Schwab Founders Celebration Sale, save up to $150 instantly on select sets of four tires. Les Schwab Tires, doing the right thing since 1952.
number 2 seed Henley up 44-27 over number 15 seed St. Helens here at halftime of this OSA On Point Community Credit Union 4A girls basketball first round game. Henley well on their way to making their second straight state quarterfinal appearance. Matt Bowling here alongside Josh Eldridge. Let's look at the first half scoring. Annie Campos, what a half. What a game she's having so far. 21 points in the first half. She was outscoring St. Helens by herself for a little while until Devin Lee put up a 10-point second quarter for the Lions. But we'll get to her in a second. Let's go down the rest of the Hornets first. So it was Annie Campos with 21, Lily Fassell with 7, Preston Shade with 5, Anna Harper with 4, Jewel Northcutt and Kennedy Modine each with 3, and Bailey Ladner with 1. For St. Helens, Devin Lee, the sophomore, averaging 12.3 points per game on the season. She had 16 in the first half, including 10 in the second quarter. She's showing why she was honorable mention All-State last year as a freshman. She has made some tough shots, given St. Helens a lot of speed in transition, too. She has 16. Maddie Hancock has 3. Maisie McDowell, Bella Michael, and McKenna Harden all have 2. And Caitlin Keefe has 1. One thing notable for the Lions, D.A. Davidson, their second leading scorer, averaging 11.2 points per game, has 0. She had to sit for the rest of the second quarter after picking up her third foul of the game just about a minute in.
Yeah, you can tell St. Helens is kind of playing in uncharted waters. They're, you know, they only have one of their leading scorers really on the floor. And I got to say, Devin Lee, they've done a good job of kind of giving her the keys here. She's played a lot of ISO ball, getting inside. She's really the only player I've maybe seen all season who's been able to penetrate the Henley defense by herself and get buckets. She's at 16 points right now. She's the reason her team is as close as they are.
Yeah, she's special. I just watching her for one half, I can tell she is special.
Yeah.
I'm sure St. Helens is going to be looking forward to having her for 2 more years. So you can see on our live stream, the Henley boys are out there getting shots up. They are the number 7 seed, and they'll face the number 10 seed Astoria. Game scheduled for about 3 o'clock here. I think we're still on pace for that to happen on time, despite the long first half with I don't even know how many foul calls. It had to be close to 30, maybe.
Well, I mean, I know I looked at the clock. Both teams were in the bonus with about 3.5 minutes left in that second quarter. I didn't pick up on that in the first quarter. But, yeah, a lot of fouls have slowed this game down a lot. And Henley's comfortable playing in a slower game, although they like to play a sped-up pace. It's just been all Hornets so far, though. It doesn't really matter the pace of the game when you got someone like Annie Campos filling up the cup.
Absolutely. She's, you know, you mentioned that Devin Lee is the only one this season that's kind of been able to really penetrate Henley's defense. Well, Annie Campos is doing what she's done to pretty much every defense she's faced all season. It's sort of the reverse in a sense.
But, I mean, this is great experience for St. Helens. I mean, by the way, this game isn't over by any means, but you're down, you know, considerably at this point in the game. Devin Lee, we talked about it. She's a sophomore getting this big game experience, and she's controlling the tempo for her team. This is exactly what Annie Campos did when she was a sophomore. And so we talk about the growth that she's seen. I mean, they were the 16 seed when Campos was a sophomore, and she went up there and controlled the pace against Philomath that year, who was the top seed in the state. So this is a growing moment, and I really do like what I see from St. Helens.
They'll have a chance to cut into this 17-point deficit in about 3.5 minutes. We'll take a break. Matt Bowling here alongside Josh Eldridge. You're watching Henley Basketball on MyBasin.com and listening on 104.3 and 960 Sports.
Comfortable and not corporate. At Clownfall Subaru, we built our business on that simple promise. Well, that and some of the best people you're ever going to meet. Hi, I'm Rob Cedar, General Manager at Clownfall Subaru. Our 62 employees make it easy for us to live up to our comfortable, not corporate philosophy. Friendly faces, easy answers, straight talk, fairness, and exceptional service. These are the things you expect. These are the things that all of our people deliver. Our management team, sales pros, certified service and body shop techs, lot attendants, and detail experts are all 100% focused on you, local people putting their friends and neighbors first. At Clown Falls Subaru, that's the only way we do business. It's comfortable, not corporate. Our team members also spend hundreds of hours each year supporting local charities and events through the Subaru Love Promise. That's the kind of people they are. We're very proud of them. They're your friends, they're your neighbors, they're glad to know you, and they want you to be glad to know them too. I'm Rob, and this is what makes us comfortable, not corporate.
This is where unconditional love and immeasurable happiness reside. This is home. Coldwell Banker, where home begins.
Second half about to get underway here at Henley. Hornets with a 44-27 lead over St. Helens. I want to give a big shout out to the Henley boosters for putting up the rights fee for this broadcast. I know, Josh, you've been here a lot longer than I have. This is only my first year broadcasting Henley games, but I've been really impressed throughout football and basketball season with how great the Henley boosters are and how much they support what we're doing. Annie Campos pulls up from the right block and sinks it. She's got 23 and the Hornets have a 46-29 lead as D.A. Davidson gets her first points of the game on the other end after the Campos bucket. Coming right back is Annie Campos. She misses, but Anna Harper gets the putback on the rebound. 48-29, Henley leads. 7:15 to go in the third quarter. They feed Lee on the inside. She can't make the shot from the left block. Shade bringing it up. She's got it on the right wing. She throws it to Lily Fassell on the left wing. Up to Annie Campos up top. Northcutt with it on the right side, has it stripped away by Maisie McDowell. Devin Lee bringing it up the left side. Davidson on the left block, throws it up over two defenders, the shot won't fall. Fassell in transition, stops at the top of the key. Shade on the right wing. Bounces it to the right short corner where Jewel Northcutt pulls up and connects. 50-29 Henley, 6:10 to go in the third quarter. Lee drives and draws a foul on the left side.
One thing we weren't able to mention in halftime was the turnover numbers for both teams. After a half of play, Henley only turned the ball over four times. They take care of it really nicely. St. Helens gave Henley the ball seven times.
Davidson at the top of the key, going to work on Anna Harper. Fouled as Annie Campos came in to try to trap her. Going to get the shot up and D.A. Davidson. And it's going to take two free throws. 5:57 left in the third quarter. She makes her first. Kennedy Modine checks in for Anna Harper. She got called for the foul. That was her third. Davidson makes the second free throw. So it's a 50-31 lead for the Hornets. 5:55 to go in the third quarter. Annie Campos at the top of the key. Throws to Modine on the right side. Campos, left wing three, won't fall. Rebounded by Lee. Lee, outlet pass to Davidson, or an attempted outlet pass, went off the back of Jewel Northcutt and into the hands of Preston Shade. Shade with it between the circles, throws to Annie Campos on the left wing. Dribbles it in, kicks to Shade, who pulls a right wing three and misses. Rebound comes back to her. Pull up from the right short corner won't fall. And that time Kayla Dewitt gets the rebound. In the left corner, Harden driving, baseline, floater won't go. Rebound tipped up, pulled down by McDowell. They feed Davidson, and she scores from the right side.
Good ball movement there by St. Helens to find the open player in the post.
Back down to a 17-point lead for Henley, 4:50 to go in the third quarter. Campos spinning around Davidson, her shot too strong from the right block. Ref takes a tumble in transition. Maisie McDowell pulls a right wing three. That won't go. Rebound out to Harden. Her three is off the mark. Annie Campos grabs it. At the top of the key. Over to Modine on the right side. Bounced in the paint for Shade. Back out to Annie Campos. Her left slot three is no good. McDowell the rebound. Outlet pass to Duick. Duick on the left side. Back out to Davidson. Davidson trying to drive on Fassell. Davidson at the left elbow. Double teamed. Bowls over Jewel Northcutt, and Northcutt gets called for the foul. That's Northcutt's second, third of the quarter on Henley. St. Helens has yet to be called for one. There's 4:01 left in the third.
That's a difference from the first half, where at this point we were almost into the bonus in the second quarter.
Still a 50-33 lead for Henley. Inbound. Rolls all the way to the Henley bench after bouncing off of somebody's leg. They say it's still St. Helens' ball. Anna Harper back in for Henley as Jewel Northcutt comes to the bench. McDowell inbounds it to Devin Lee. Picked up at half court by Maya Mock. Over to McDowell. On the left side, Maisie McDowell. Pass off target for a cutting Michael, and it's out of bounds. Trying to go to her at the top of the key, but threw it a bit too far behind her. Annie Campos brings it across half court. Dribbles up to the top of the key, now moves right. Throws it right to Preston Shade. Gets it back. Left wing, Senya Campos splits the defense. Loses the ball on the way up. It's loose in the paint. And a tie-up is called. Possession arrow points to St. Helens. Maisie McDowell inbounding from the right block on the baseline. 3:23 left in the third. Henley up 50-33. Into Devin Lee. Lee has it stolen from her. Annie Campos cashes it in for a quick bucket. She has 25 points. And Henley has a 52-33 lead with 3:07 left in the third quarter. Davidson tried to get the shot up over Senya Campos. She took the ball from her. into Harper. Harper's shot bounces in from the paint. And we've got a timeout called by St. Helens. 54-33. Henley on top. 2:54 to go in the third quarter. You're watching Hornets basketball on MyBasin.com and listening on 104.3 and 960 Sports.
What rocks great?
Participate.
Where does greatness start?
Here, in the classroom.
On the stage.
In the pool.
On the field.
Where will your greatness take you?
To better grades.
To more friends. Yeah!
Be great.
Participate! 54-33, Henley with 2:54 left in the third. Largest lead of the day for the Hornets. St. Helens gets the inbound to D.A. Davidson, who hits a contested layup from the left side. On the other end, Annie Campos driving right side baseline. Her jumper won't fall. Maya Mock the rebound. She puts it up, loses it. Rebound tip to Ladner. Her shot won't fall. Another try won't go. Anna Harper is finally fouled. That's the fourth foul on Maisie McDowell and the first of the quarter on St. Helens. Senya Campos getting set to check in for the Hornets as Anna Harper makes her first free throw. Michaela Duick checks in for St. Helens. As Harper makes her second free throw. Back to a 21-point lead for Henley. 2:26 left in the third. Devin Lee in transition. At the top of the key. Lofts it down low to Davidson. Davidson going to work on Ladner and Campos. Kicks it out to Duick. Her free throw line jumper won't fall. Harper the rebound. Harper out to Senya Campos. Her left wing three won't fall. It's rebounded by Annie Campos on the right side. She gets around Davidson, puts it up, won't go underneath. Missed rebound comes to Bailey Ladner. Bodies falling all over the place as a foul is called. It's charged to Devin Lee. That is her second on the Lions. Well, scoreboard says it's her third, even though it was announced as her second. They're sorting out a substitution here. Chloe Claughton checking in for D.A. Davidson. Ladner inbounds it to Northcutt. She pulls a left elbow jumper that won't go. Rebounded underneath by Bella Michael. Lee, guarded by Maya Mock at the top of the key. Hands it to Claughton. Claughton trying to dribble into the right lane. She hands it to Michael, who throws up a shot from the left lane that doesn't even touch the rim. Annie Campos with it on the other side. She sends it to Senya Campos, who travels on the right wing. A minute 24 left in the third quarter. Henley still up 56-35. Kayla Duick is going to inbound right in front of the Hornets bench. She gets it into Devin Lee, who is fouled in transition. Maya Mock called for the bump there. And I think Kennedy Modine is going to check in for her. She will. That's the third foul on Mock, fourth of the quarter on Henley. A minute 21 to go. Inbound to Devin Lee. Lee throws it down to Hancock, who's fouled in the paint. That puts the Lions in the bonus. So it'll be two free throws for Maddie Hancock. A minute 17 left in the third quarter. Hancock makes the first free throw. Lily Fassell checks in for Jewel Northcutt. As Hancock gets set for her second free throw, she makes it. So Henley's lead down to 56-37 with a minute 15 left in the third quarter. Modine on the right side, dribbles into the paint, throws up a floater. It won't fall. It's rebounded by Lily Fassell. Modine on the left wing. Annie Campos up top. Senya Campos, right wing, three, rolls off the rim. Rebound and putback won't fall for Lily Fassell. A second try results in a foul call. Second chances have been huge for Henley, particularly here in the second half. Fassell with two free throws. Makes the first one. She's been a force in the paint, too, for Henley, especially when Anna Harper was out. She averaged 6.1 rebounds in league play, 9.8 points, and 4.8 steals. She goes 2-for-2 from the line, so it's back to a 21-point lead for Henley. 47 seconds left in the third quarter. Lee throws it to Duick on the right side. Lee gets it back, right wing, dribbles to the free throw line. Pass tipped, stolen by Fassell. Fassell should have an easy layup on the other end, but can't convert. Ladner in to get the rebound. She gives it to Annie Campos, who dribbles her way to a missed shot. Rebound comes back to her. She throws it up off the glass. It won't fall. Finally, Kayla Duick grabs the rebound, but it's stolen by Annie Campos. Another shot misses, and another one. She gets fouled on that last one, though. I think that was about five misses underneath in a row for Henley.
They're able to just get those rebounds. I mean, they are so good on the offensive glass. Even if you get those misses, you like the effort.
9.1 seconds left in the third quarter. Annie Campos misses her first free throw. She's had a relatively quiet third quarter, only 4 points. That's brought her to 25 on the day. Make that 26 as she makes the second free throw. 7 seconds left. Devin Lee throws it down low to Chloe Claughton. Back on the perimeter. Lee's three is blocked by Modine. And that's how we end the third quarter. Henley up 59-37. 8 minutes from their second straight state tournament appearance. Matt Bowling here alongside Josh Eldridge. It's Henley basketball on mybasin.com and 104.3 and 960 Sports.
So lonely, I just sigh more. Seems like I've been waiting forever, wondering if you're coming home. I just saw your face, I know you're coming home. I swear there is no place.
This is where unconditional love and immeasurable happiness reside. This is home. Coldwell Banker, where home begins.
22-point lead as we start the fourth quarter here at the Hornets' Nest. First round of the OSA On Point Community Credit Union 4A playoffs Annie Campos feeds Jewel Northcutt underneath. Her layup from the right side was off target, out of bounds. It'll be Lions ball. Substitute Bella Michael in for Devin Lee. Looks like Lee has a little problem with her face. She's getting checked out by the trainer. Maybe a cut. Now looks like she's plugging up her nose. She's dived into the paint several times this game. So no surprise she finally takes a tough bump. Going to be tough for St. Helens to stage any sort of comeback without her. As Northcutt puts up a shot in the paint that's rebounded by D.A. Davidson. Davidson had 8 of St. Helens' 10 points in the third quarter. She didn't play almost the entire second quarter after picking up her third foul. She was scoreless in the first half. 7:08 left in this one. Henley leading 59-37 as Annie Campos brings it across half court. Over to Anna Harper on the left side. Hands it to Mock. Harper dribbling in from the right side. Throws it to Shade. Shade pulls up from the left block. Her shot's off the mark. McDowell the rebound. Up ahead to Bella Michael. Michael throws it up and in over Annie Campos. That was not an easy shot by any means. Makes it 59-39. Henley ahead with 6:25 left in the game. Outlet pass to McKenna Harden is too far ahead of her and out of bounds. It'll be Henley ball. Annie Campos across half court. At the free throw line, Northcutt dribbles it in, loses it. Kayla Duick dribbling up the left side. Hands it to Davidson. D.A. Davidson guarded by Jewel Northcutt. In from the left wing. A tough turnaround shot drops. 10 points for the sophomore. Maya Mock dribbles into the paint, throws one up. It's well short. Rebounded by Duick, and she's fouled. 5:43 left in the game. Henley leads 59-41. Lily Fassell checks in for Jewel Northcutt. Duick throws it in to Davidson. Now McDowell in transition. Left side shot. Off the mark for McKenna Harden. Lily Fassell the rebound. And Randy Denson calls timeout. 5:30 left in the game. Henley leads 59-41. Matt Bowling here alongside Josh Eldridge. This is Henley Basketball on 104.3 and 960 Sports and MyBasin.com.
Tasteless flop tires. I'm a confident backseat driver, but mom's a little stressed about spending. Remember, deep breaths and watch your speed. Even though we're watching our wallets, Les Schwab is still watching out for our safety. So turn here.
During the Les Schwab Founders Celebration Sale, save up to $150 instantly on select sets of 4 tires. Les Schwab Tires, doing the right thing since 1952.
Back with you here at the Hornet's Nest. We want to once again thank the Henley Boosters for covering the rights fee for this broadcast. As Lily Fassell's shot won't fall, Harper gets the rebound. Her putback attempt is tipped out of bounds by McDowell. It'll stay with Henley. Fassell inbounding from the left side as the officials come together for a quick chat. Are they going to change the possession here? I 5:13 left in the game. Henley's still up by 18. And now we have a ref consulting with the scorer's table.
I think they're resetting the shot clock, taking 3 seconds off, it looked like.
Good eye. 32 seconds. Harper, floater from the left side, won't fall. Modine fighting for the rebound with Davidson, who goes down. It's a tie-up. Possession arrow does point to St. Helens. That's a tough play by Kennedy Modine going up against the noticeably larger Davidson.
These Hornets are fearless, man. That's what it takes to play good defense, and they do it. They played really good defense today.
5:07 to go. Inbound to Lee. Devin Lee at the top of the key, hands it to Davidson. Davidson at the left elbow, kicks it out to Lee. Left wing three rattles in. Those are the first points of the half for Devin Lee. She had 16 in the first half. 4:42 left in the fourth quarter. Henley up 59-43. Harper drives in from the left side. Her shot misses. Lee in front of her own bench gives it to Davidson. Davidson, deep three off the front of the rim. Fassell grabs the board. Modine across half court, onto the right side. Anna Harper in the left slot, drives, gets fouled. Harper gave a little pump fake before going into the left lane, was fouled on the shot. 4:08 left in the game. Anna Harper makes her first free throw. Senya Campos checks in for Lily Fassell. As Maddie Hancock checks in for D.A. Davidson. Harper goes 2-for-2 from the line, so it's 61-43 Henley. We are about halfway through the fourth quarter. Pass saved from going out of bounds by McKenna Harden, but turned over. It fell right to Kennedy Modine. Modine pulls a right wing three and connects. The other way, Bella Michael is fouled. 64-43 Henley, 3:46 to go. Preston Shade picked up her fourth personal foul there. And Bella Michael makes the first free throw. .346 remaining in this ball game. Michael makes the second free throw to reduce Henley's lead to 64-45. And Maddie Hancock is down. Coming off that made free throw, looks like we're going to have an injury timeout. So we'll step aside.
Sports was kind of what defined me as a person. I loved to play every sport I could possibly play. The Abbeys was really the family stomping ground for all of our community. Saturday afternoon soccer tournaments, we'd head over to Abbeys afterwards. And then when we got up into middle school, on our way home, we'd stop at Abbeys after basketball games. When I go home, I want to see two things when I drive through Winston. I want to see my Abbeys, and I want to see my high school. And those are the two memories that stick out the most to me.
Maddie Hancock being helped off the court for St. Helens. She was lined up for the second free throw and just went down immediately afterward. Looks like maybe a problem with her knee, and that's definitely not something you want to see, especially in kind of a non-contact injury. Harper's floater in the paint won't fall. Tipped out of bounds. It'll go to the Lions. 3.5 minutes left in the game. Henley with a 19-point lead. Claughton in the backcourt. Now McDowell across the line. Feeds Harden on the left block. Her shot won't fall, but she draws a foul. Two shots for McKenna Harden, who has 2 points on the day. First one rolls in. Second one won't fall. So Henley up 64-46 with 3:12 left in the game. Annie Campos drops her defender but misses the shot. Putback won't go from the right side. Now a third chance rolls in. 27 points for Annie Campos. Hornets almost force a turnover as they're up 20 with 2:51 to go. Left side, Devin Lee. Lee weaving her way through the lane. A little up and under action there. She's got 21. Shot on the other end won't fall, tipped out of bounds. Henley ball, Hornets with a 66-48 lead with 2:37 left. Caitlin Keefe checking in for the Lions in place of Bella Michael. Looks like all of the seniors are now out there for St. Helens as Annie Campos scores again. She has 30. 2:20 to go. Henley up 68-48. Three off the mark for Devin Lee. Rebounded by Senya Campos. Kennedy Modine. Three rolls out and in for Senya Campos. Those are her first points of the day, and it gives Henley a 71-48 lead with a minute 48 remaining. Offensive foul called as Devin Lee charged into the right lane. And a full substitution coming in for Randy Denson. Meredith Brown, Lily Fassell. Bailey Ladner, Preston Shade, Anna Harper, Lily Fassell, and Meredith Brown are out there. Minute 38 remaining, a 23-point lead for Henley. And the reality is beginning to set in on the St. Helens bench. Never fun to have it end like this, but still, one of the best seasons this team has had in some time. And it's looking like it may only go up from here. You return your two leading scorers. And Jillian Ross-Dean, second-year head coach, seems like she's really building something here at St. Helens. She was 7-18 last year. Member of the St. Helens Sports Hall of Fame. She graduated in 2013. Went on to play 1 year of volleyball and 3 years of basketball at Pacific University, where she was a career 38.8% three-point shooter. She's already led St. Helens to more wins as a head coach in 2 years than they had in her 4 years there as a player. Of course, it's tough when you play in a league like they do and you get the 15 seed, have to make a 7-8 hour trip to face a Henley team that, with only a few exceptions, has been an absolute buzzsaw this season.
I'm really excited for St. Helens' future, and I think they should be too. This is a great experience, especially for their sophomores who've come in here and scored the ball well against a tough defense. Nothing to hang your head about if you're the Lions fan.
Henley's just going to dribble this one out. And for the second year in a row, the Hornets are going to the state tournament. 71-48, the final score. Number 2 seed rolling over the number 15 seed. When you talk about the coaching job that Jillian Rothstein did at St. Helens, how about Randy Denson? Fourth season at Henley. He's led the Hornets to now back-to-back Skyline Conference championships and back-to-back state quarterfinals. Henley seniors getting a nice salute from Bob Shambrose, the PA guy, as this will be their final game at the Hornets' Nest. Pretty good way to end it. We're going to take a break, give you your final scoring on the other side. Matt Bowling here alongside Josh Eldridge. You're watching Henley basketball on mybasin.com and listening on 104.3 and 960 Sports.
Comfortable and not corporate. At Clownfall Subaru, we built our business on that simple promise. Well, that and some of the best people you're ever going to meet. Hi, I'm Rob Cedar, General Manager at Clownfall Subaru. Our 62 employees make it easy for us to live up to our comfortable, not corporate philosophy. Friendly faces, easy answers, straight talk, fairness, and exceptional service. These are the things you expect. These are the things that all of our people deliver. Our management team, sales pros, certified service and body shop techs, lot attendants, and detail experts are all 100% focused on you, local people putting their friends and neighbors first. At Clownfall Subaru, that's the only way we do business. It's comfortable, not corporate. Our team members also spend hundreds of hours each year supporting local charities and events through the Subaru Love Promise. That's the kind of people they are. We're very proud of them. They're your friends, they're your neighbors, they're glad to know you, and they want you to be glad to know them too.
Introduce Smith Bates Marcom Solutions, your trusted partner in marketing and communication. We specialize in crafting compelling campaigns, eye-catching graphics, and impactful branding materials.
Smith Bates is like working with dependable friends. They always help us build our professional image.
Through the innovative strategies that the team at Smith Bates suggested, we've been able to give the brand at Calor the boost that it desperately needed.
Unlock your potential with Smith Bates Marcom Solutions.
. 71-48, the final score here at Henley as the number 2 seed Hornets book their ticket to the state quarterfinals for the second year in a row with a win over the number 15 seed St. Helens. We got your final scoring here for you, starting with the victorious Henley Hornets. Annie Campos, 30 points, 21 in the first half. Anna Harper with 12. Kennedy Modine with 6. Lily Fussell with 9. Then Kennedy Modine with 6. Jewel Northcutt and Preston Shade each with 5. Senya Campos with 3. And Bailey Ladner with 1. For St. Helens, Devin Lee, the sophomore, with 21 points. We mentioned St. Helens has a bright future, bringing back their two leading scorers Devin Lee is their top scorer. She is certain to be a cornerstone of this Lions team going forward. She was followed by D.A. Davidson with 10 points. Another sophomore, second leading scorer who looked really good for them, but was severely limited after picking up her third foul in, I think, the first minute of the second quarter. Finished with 10 points all in the second half. 6 points for Bella Michael, 5 for Maddie Hancock, 3 for McKenna Harden, 2 for Maisie McDowell, and 1 for Caitlin Keefe. Not much to talk about with that game. Just Henley did what they needed to do, really took control from the get-go. And good warm-up game for what's probably going to be a pretty tough field for the Hornets at Forest Grove next week.
And we can take a look at who they might be playing. It's between Seaside and Madras, a couple of really good squads. I mean, we mentioned Seaside's from that same conference, the Coapa League, that that St. Helens is from, and Madras always a tough bit as well. I believe the Hornets played Madras last year at the tournament, beat him in the consolation side of the bracket. And so it's a good outlook for Henley right now. They're scheduled to play in the late game, although that is subject to change, of course. But moving forward for Henley, they seem to be in good shape.
Henley boys coming up next. They're the number 7 seed, and they play the number 10 seed Astoria Fishermen, who've also made about an 8-hour drive from the top of the state to be here. Josh Eldridge will have the call on that one. He will be joined by Kevin Petrick. And that means it's the end of the day for me. Want to once again give a big shout-out to the Henley Boosters, who put up the money to buy the broadcast rights for this game. Definitely a huge help to have them covering that. And we appreciate being able to bring this game not just to Henley fans watching, but also to the St. Helens fans. I'm sure there's a lot of them who weren't able to make that trip down here, so glad we were able to let them watch as well. So we're going to take a break and get ready for the boys' game. It's set to start in about 20 minutes. Matt Bowling signing off here from Henley. Going to hand it over to Josh Eldridge on the other side of a pretty lengthy break that we're going to have here. You're watching Henley basketball on MyBasin.com and listening on 104.3 and 960 Sports.
And a very pleasant good afternoon, basketball fans, and welcome to the OSAA On Point Community Credit Union 4A Boys Basketball Playoffs on 104.3 and 960 Sports and MyBasin.com. So glad to be with you tonight as the Henley Hornets get ready to take on the Astoria Fishermen for the second year in a row in this Sweet 16 matchup. Josh Eldridge, Kevin Petrick with you, and Mark McDaniel coming to you live from Henley High School inside the Hornets' Nest, just a few minutes south of downtown Klamath Falls for this playoff matchup. Hornets are the home team. Astoria Fishermen making the long trip down from the Oregon coast and being greeted with a frosty Saturday afternoon. We'll get you details on both of these teams, the seasons they've had so far, plus a look at the 4A bracket. This is the final game remaining out of the Sweet 16. We know seven teams that are headed to Forest Grove High School next week. This one will decide the eight that will join those seven squads in the Elite Eight at Forest Grove High School. Details on all of that and more as we continue your coverage of Henley basketball in the OSAA On Point Community Credit Union 4A Boys Basketball State Playoffs on 104.3 and 960 Sports and MyBasin.com.
So lonely, I just sighed more. Seems like I've been waiting forever, wondering if you're coming home.
I just saw your face. I know you're coming home. I swear there is no place that feels
This is where unconditional love and immeasurable happiness reside. This is home. Coldwell Banker, where home begins.
Introduce Smith Bates Marcom Solutions, your trusted partner in marketing and communication. We specialize in crafting compelling campaigns, eye-catching graphics, and impactful branding materials.
Smith Bates is like working with dependable friends. They always help us build our professional image.
Through the innovative strategies that the team at Smith Bates suggested, we've been able to give the brand at Calor the boost that it desperately needed.
Unlock your potential with Smith Bates Marcom Solutions.
Super.
We welcome you back to Henley High School for the OSAA On Point Community Credit Union 4A Boys Basketball Playoffs on 104.3 and 960 Sports and MyBasin.com. This is the final Sweet 16 matchup to be played in the state. Let's take a look now at how the rest of the games have shaken out so far. Again, with everything else being decided, we know who is headed to the Elite Eight except for this game. So starting from the upper left-hand part of the bracket, as we take a look at Cascade beating LeGrand 77-37. Madras beat North Marion 84-70, so it'll be the Cougars against Madras in the first game of the day at the tournament. Philomath bested Marshfield 49-37, and Baker beat Newport 60-52. Those teams will meet up in the B game, the second game of four at the tournament. On this side of the bracket, Crook County upset Seaside 46-37, the 14 seed, knocking off number three Seaside in that game. We also had Marist taking care of business against Phoenix, 59-30. So again, Crook County, the Cowboys, will play the Spartans at the tournament. And then the winner of this game will meet Junction City, the two seed, beating Scappoose 60-31. Junction City, that's a tough draw for either one of these teams, but both will be happy to make it to the state tournament, which begins Thursday at Forest Grove High School. These two teams, the Fishermen and the Hornets, they met last year in this game, and it was a slim victory for the Hornets. We're going to take a break, and when we come back, we'll talk a little bit about that matchup, plus the seasons that each of these two teams have had thus far. That's coming up next as pregame coverage continues from Klamath Falls, Oregon. This is the OSAA On Point Community Credit Union 4A Boys Basketball Sweet 16 on 104.3 and 960 Sports and MyBasin.com.
Comfortable and not great. At Clownfall Subaru, we built our business on that simple promise. Well, that and some of the best people you're ever going to meet. Hi, I'm Rob Cedar, General Manager at Clownfall Subaru. Our 62 employees make it easy for us to live up to our comfortable, not corporate philosophy. Friendly faces, easy answers, straight talk, fairness, and exceptional service. These are the things you expect. These are the things that all of our people deliver. Our management team, sales pros, certified service and body shop techs, lot attendants, and detail experts are all 100% focused on you, local people putting their friends and neighbors first. At Clownfall Subaru, that's the only way we do business. It's comfortable, not corporate. Our team members also spend hundreds of hours each year supporting local charities and events through the Subaru Love Promise. That's the kind of people they are. We're very proud of them. They're your friends, they're your neighbors, they're glad to know you, and they want you to be glad to know them too. I'm Rob, and this is what makes us comfortable, not corporate.
Union 4A boys basketball playoffs on 104.3 and 960 Sports and MyBasin.com. Before we get started with the broadcast tonight, I want to give a big thank you to the Henley Booster Club, who's allowed us to get on the air tonight. As we move into the playoffs, you have to pay video rights fees to the Oregon Schools Activities Association. The Henley Booster Club really helped us out by covering that and allow us to get us on the air to bring the broadcast not only to Hornets fans, but also all of you Astoria fans who are listening across the state and anyone who's just interested in some boys basketball playoffs. Big thank you to the Henley Booster Club for allowing us to get on the air. They want us to remind you that on March 13th, Henley High School is hosting a tri-tip dinner fundraiser to raise some money for the senior class as they get ready for their sober grad party. They're serving up some Pop Howard's Rub and Howard's Meat Center steak, and all delicious stuff can be found on our website, mybasin.com, if you're interested in supporting the Henley senior class and, of course, the Henley Boosters. As we get into this matchup, the Hornets playing the Fishermen for the second time in the Sweet 16. Last year when these two teams met up, it was a 65-62 victory for Henley. Kind of the game, though, that you felt like if it had been played for two more minutes, Astoria might have come back and won that game because the Fishermen made a run in the fourth quarter, although Marcus McCready led his team to a victory. He led his team with 14 points in that game against Merrick Benesch, who is back with the Fishermen this year. He scored 24 in that game, led the Fishermen in scoring this year with 19 points. We'll talk a little bit more about that later on. But the Fishermen finished second out of the Coapa League. Although they had a better overall record of 18-6 and were ranked higher than the Hornets in the final rankings, they ended up having to travel for this game because Henley won another Skyline Conference title, 7-1 in league play, 15-7 overall. Again, this is just one of those deals where if you don't win your league, you got to hit the road. And Seaside was actually the league champion out of that Coapa League along the coast. Astoria making about a 7-hour bus trip yesterday. Made it just in time for the snow to hit them on their way down to the Klamath Basin, but really excited for this matchup. Henley's trying to make it back to the Elite Eight after finishing fifth at last year's tournament. Astoria trying to make it back to the Elite Eight for the first time since 2016. They've lost two consecutive games coming into this matchup against two top five teams, number five Seaside and number three Philomath. But before that, they won 7 of 8, and they started the season 10-0. We know this team can ball, and they certainly showed it last year in the basin. As we take a look at how these teams have shaped up on the offensive and defensive end, Astoria is averaging about 67.2 points per game this season and only allowing 52.8. Henley, on the other hand, well, they only score a shade over 50 points per game, and they allow 47. By the way, 47 points per game. That's the third best defense in the state at the 4A level, only behind number 3 Seaside and number 4 Baker. So Henley, they're going to try to slow down tonight's game. Well, Astoria, they like to shoot the ball. They like to move the ball up and down the floor quickly. It'll be a game of differing styles tonight in the Sweet 16 of the OSAA On Point Community Credit Union 4A Boys Basketball Playoffs. We're going to step aside one more time. When we return, it's time for starting lineups and tip-off tonight on 104.3 and 960 Sports and MyBasin.com.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to this.
Wait. All I do is wait. So lonely, I just sigh and mourn. Seems like I've been waiting forever. Wonder.
This is where unconditional love and immeasurable happiness reside. This is home. Coldwell Banker, where home begins.
Threads. There are many threads that run through our region. There are churches and schools and little league teams that bring us together and bind us into communities. There are roads and cars. There are houses and jobs and businesses, all woven together to make the fabric of our communities. There are financial threads that are part of that tapestry as well. For over 80 years, it's been our pleasure to be headquartered here, providing financial services to generations of our friends and neighbors. From that first savings account, to retirement planning, and all of the cars and houses and groceries in between, we keep your money local, investing it back into our communities, adding more threads to the fabric to make our community stronger. Pacific Crest Federal Credit Union. Find your path.
Spangled Banner performed by Henley Choir Director and Assistant Football Coach, Mr. Christopher Benjamin. We're also awaiting the colors to be retired from the Henley JROTC. After that, it means we are just about ready for basketball this afternoon on 104.3 and 960 Sports and MyBasin.com. Thanks again to the Henley Booster Club for helping us get on the air today, especially this video feed that you're watching if you're watching on mybasin.com. Give thanks to the Henley Boosters for helping us get out here. This is the OSAA On Point Community Credit Union 4A Boys Basketball Playoffs, and it's time now to meet the starting lineups first for the Astoria Fishermen. I want to thank everybody who's joining us from Astoria and around the state of Oregon for this afternoon's broadcast. Okay, starting a sophomore, number 0, Quinn Gore. A senior, number 2, Owen Williams. A senior, number 5, Beck Olson. Senior, number 12, Benton Moore. And senior, number 13, Merrick Benesh. The Fishermen are coached by Alex Eterno and assisted by Tony Robinson. The Fishermen finished this season with an 18-6 overall record. Now time to meet the starting five for the hometown Henley Hornets. Starting at guard, a senior, number 10, standing 5'10". It's Aiden Hayes. Starting at a forward position, a senior standing 6'3", number 12, Owen Harper. Starting at a guard position, number 22, a senior standing 5'11", Chris Janney. Number 24, a senior standing 6'3", it's Luke Bennett. And number 44, the big man standing 6'7", a senior, Marcus McCready. The Henley Hornets are coached by Luke Hammond, assisted by Thomas Sloney and Brian Stock. They finished 15-7 in 2024. I'm Josh Eldridge, glad to be with you this afternoon. Kevin Petrick alongside with me in the booth at Henley High School. They call it the Hornet's Nest, and we've got a packed house tonight, Kevin.
Yes, we have a good turnout once again. You know, coming here last year is going to help Astoria a little bit.
I think so.
This is a tough trip, and they made it last year, so it isn't their first shot here. They know it's a tough place to play, and Henley's very good at home.
Henley tonight wearing their home white uniforms with Hornets written across their chest in blue trim, white text. Astoria in their road black uniforms tonight. As the Hornets control the opening tip, they move from left to right. Aiden Hayes has it, hands it over to Bennett. Bennett trying to go to work against Olsen on the block, hands it to Janney, cutting down low, bouncing it to Harper, who cuts to the rim and lays it up and in. The Hornets and Owen Harper strike first. They lead 2-0, 7:40 to go in the first. Coming along the near side, it's Astoria. Quinn Gore terminates the dribble, tries to find Benesh coming off a screen for a corner three. Won't go, and Luke Bennett collects the rebound. Bennett shoves it ahead to Hayes on the far side of the floor, dumps it down low to McCready, close to the rim, and he scores. 2 points for Marcus, gives his team a 4-0 lead with 7:20 to go in the first. Here's the Fisherman coming the other way. Gore switches to his left hand, coming along the near side. Gets around Aiden Hayes, but can't convert close to the rim. And McCready cleans up the rebound. Gets it ahead to Janney, who crosses the timeline for the Hornets. Janney left alone, top of the key. He's going to get rid of it to Harper. Harper throws it to Bennett, head of the key. Bennett now putting it on the deck. Gets it back to Janney on the right wing. Janney bouncing it back to Bennett, trying to call for a screen. Hands it off to Harper. Harper brings it around the far side, bouncing it to Hayes in the far corner. 10 on the shot clock for Henley. Hayes backs out, has it tipped away for a moment. Loose balls collected by Janney. Now 6 to shoot for the Hornets. Over to Bennett on the far side. Dribbling inside. 14-foot jumper for Bennett. Hits the back of the rim and won't go. It's Benesh who cleans up the rebound. He brings it into the front court for Astoria. Stops on the right wing, guarded by Janney. Dishes it over to Williams. Williams now driving the left side. Spins around, kicks it out to Gore. Gore driving the right block, loses the dribble and has it picked away by Janney. Great defense by the Hornets, and here they come. Janney into the front court, handing it to Hayes. 6:15 to go in the first, and Henley leads 4-0. Hayes getting it past half court, driving along the right side, stops from 13, bounces it to McCready. Fields defense from two fishermen, throws it off the glass, won't go. Harper with the first putback, no. The second one he's fouled, and I believe this one might be offensive. Going against Owen Harper. And that'll be a turnover, and Astoria takes it with 6:02 to go in the first. They're down by 4.
Owen was battling down there for the rebound. Just got caught using his hands a little bit. That's his first foul.
Quinn Gore, the sophomore, bringing it up the floor for Astoria. Throws it to Benesh. Benesh at the right elbow. Jumper is too strong. Won't go. Rebound is batted out, collected by Williams. Pardon me, that's Olsen. Olsen throws it over to Williams, steps into a long triple, head of the key, front iron, no good, and Harper with the rebound. differing styles between these two teams. Obviously, the Hornets like to feed McCready down low. Astoria opting for some mid-range and long three-point jumpers early. Harper zips it over to Bennett in the far corner. Bennett dumps it down low to Janney on the left block. Tries to get it back out to Bennett for a left corner three. Won't go. Rebound is still a loose ball on the right wing. Players falling on it and a held ball. Aiden Hayes putting Quinn Gore in a bit of a wrestling move there to try to tie him up. Possession goes the way of the Fishermen.
Both teams playing aggressively. Both started in man-to-man defense here.
All right, Quinn Gore bringing it up the floor, a first-team all-league selection out of the Coapa League. He hands it over to Williams. Williams driving along the right side of the floor and lays it up and in. Uncontested layup cuts the Henley lead in half. It's 4-2 with 5 minutes to go in the first. Aiden Hayes trying to direct a little bit of traffic, standing at the half-court logo, the big H inside the Hornets' nest. Here's McCready now with it on the left elbow. Trying to go to work inside, but it's picked away by Williams. Williams against Harper in transition, leaves the layup short, but he's fouled. And the groans from the home faithful here inside the Hornets' nest. It's a fine time to let you know the officials tonight from the Klamath County Officials Association, Robbie Cesena, Jeff Sturgeon, and Craig Connor.
You can see Astoria's trying to attack from the outside. They'll either take the jump shot, or they have a quick first step. A lot of their guards have a quick first step, and they'll drive to the basket like they did on that last play.
Owen Williams makes the first free throw there. He's also a first-team all-league selection this season, averaging about 14.5 points per game for the Fishermen. Here's his second free throw to tie it, and it hangs on the rim and drops. Tied up at four with 4:44 to go in the first. Bryson Montag has checked into the game, dumps it down low to Bennett. Pump fakes, gets the defender to jump in the bucket for Bennett.
That was a reverse layup for Luke, took the foul, and followed through to make the hoop as well. Astoria showed press that time. Henley did a good job passing around it and getting an easy basket.
Free throw good by Bennett, gives his team a three-point lead, 7-4 with 4.5 to go in the first. Pass goes out of bounds, but the Fishermen hold on to it. By the way, we mentioned Montag checked in. He came in for Owen Harper, who picked up his second foul not too long ago. Here's Owen Williams taking a screen right, trying to drive against the Henley defense. Kicks it out to Benesh. Benesh has his pocket picked by Bennett. And here come the Hornets. Aiden Hayes into the front court. Hayes maneuvering left, hands it to Bennett. Bennett stutter stepping around the defense, spins to his left, kicks it out to Hayes. Hayes pump fakes, now driving inside along the baseline, has his shot rejected by the Fishermen, but the Hornets collect the rebound. Here's Janney with it on the right wing. Janney fires a fastball into Montag, and he converts close to the cup.
That was a fastball. A nice pass down low. Easy hoop.
9-4, Henley. 3:55 to go in the first. On the other side, it was Williams. Fired up a contested mid-range shot that doesn't go, and McCready with the rebound. Trip to the Elite Eight on the line this afternoon at Henley High School, and the Hornets lead by 5 about halfway through the first quarter. Bennett on the other side steps back beyond the arc for a triple, leaves it short. Benesh with the rebound. Here's Merrick Benesh, the leading scorer for the Fishermen, kicking it over to Williams. Williams skating past the defender and scoring. 9-6, Henley still in front, 3.5 to go in the first. Williams has got all the points today so far for the Fishermen. Here's Hayes. Hayes handing it to Janney, top of the key now to Montag, throws it out to Bennett, fires one down low to McCready on the left block, who's fouled on the shot. Marcus heading to the line for a pair.
This game is a lot like many of the games we've seen, Josh. Marcus gets that ball inside. He's drawn two, three people. A lot of very crowded in there, but Henley will look to him first. He has quite a size advantage, and he's at the line right now.
McCready misses his first free throw, but no doubt they look to him a lot, averaging 19.9 points per game and just under 13 rebounds as well. McCready also averages about 3.5 blocks per game this year. He is a stat sheet stuffer, yeah. And a big part of this team. He will make his second free throw as Henley now back up by 4. 10-6, 3:08 to go in the first quarter. Here's the Fishermen. Benesh kicks it out to Olsen. He takes a quick three, too strong. Rebound collected by Montag underneath, and he throws it ahead to Bennett. Bennett's going to cross the half-court stripe for the Hornets. Crosses to his left, finds some room down low, gets it to McCready. A nice pass, and McCready throws up a layup that doesn't go. Fisherman coming the other way. Here's Gore. Gore trying to drive the right side, loses the dribble for a moment. High off the glass, no good. And McCready with the rebound. Aiden Hayes bringing it up the floor for the Hornets. 2.5 to go in the first. Henley up 10-6. Hayes throwing it over to Joe Janius. Checked into the game. Joe over to Luke Bennett. Dribbles in. He thought about a triple. Thinks twice. Kicks it to Hayes. Hayes driving the near baseline. Bounce pass to Montag. Tries to use the window. Won't go. Rebound batted out to Joe Janney. Joe from about 10 feet out. It rattles out. No good. And Gore with the rebound. Here comes Quinn Gore. Throws it over to Benesh. Left alone for a triple. Benesh hits the front of the rim. No good. Now Joe Janney. Throwing ahead to Aiden Hayes, who will cross the timeline for Henley. Under 2 minutes to go in the first. Henley up 10-6. Pass intended for Joe in the near corner was tipped by Cannon Huber, who's checked into the game for Astoria. The sophomore getting some action in this Sweet 16 matchup with the OSAA On Point Community Credit Union 4A Boys Basketball Playoffs. Inbound pass goes to McCready. He throws it to Joe. Joe Janney now into the corner to Bennett. Drives inside the arc. Kicks it back outside to Joe Janney. Tries to get it to Hayes in the corner, but again it's Huber who gets his hand on the pass and knocks it out of bounds.
Astoria very good on the perimeter, even defensively. Getting their hands on a lot of passes.
Bennett gets it to McCready on the inbound pass beyond the arc. Back to Bennett and a whistle. There was some contact between Olsen and Hayes, and this one is actually going to go against Olsen. Blew right through the screen that Hayes had set, and a foul. Third team foul for the Fishermen. A minute 40 to go in the first, and a four-point lead for Henley. McCready to inbound. Tries to get it to Bennett, but again tipped out of bounds by Huber.
Had three or four of those just on this possession. Yeah.
McCready to inbound, and are they whistling a foul? What? Unsure here. But it looks like we're ready for basketball. Inbound pass to Aiden Hayes. He throws it to Joe Janney, head of the key. Joe back to Aiden Hayes, now to Luke Bennett. Bennett throws it to Hayes. Hayes down low to McCready. Close to the rim and an offensive foul as McCready tried to go to the rim. A strong move, too strong for the official.
Yeah, he really is surrounded down there, so he has to be careful. If he's going to make that step toward the basket, he needs to make sure the player behind him is not set.
Here's Quinn Gore moving it into the front court for Astoria. Benesh now on the left wing. Benesh against Janney, takes a screen right, trying to drive inside, kicks it back out to Olsen. Olsen now far side to Williams, hands it to Gore. Gore brings it around, head of the key, 16 to shoot for the Fishermen. Throws it to Benesh, steps into a long triple, no good again for Benesh. He's come up empty on all of his three-point shots so far. And here's Aiden Hayes, throws it back out to Bennett. Left alone for a triple, Bennett, back iron, no good. Here's Quinn Gore trying to race up the floor for the Fishermen. Stops on the right wing. Throws it to Benesh. Benesh trying to go to work against Joe Janney. Hands it over to Williams. Now back to Gore. Gore throws it to Benesh in the far corner. Thought about a three. Now driving inside. A right-hand floater rattles in. First points of the night for Benesh. Cuts the lead to 2 for Henley. 10-8, 35 seconds to go. 2 seconds, separate shot and game clock. Pass intended for Janney is touched out of bounds by Beck Olsen. And so Henley, another possession, but active hands on the defensive end for Astoria. Inbound goes into the backcourt to Aiden Hayes as he brings it up. Now to Joe Janney. Janney bouncing it back over to Hayes. Hayes, head of the key, drives left, gets it to Bennett, and a whistle. They're going to call an offensive foul again away from the ball.
Astoria switched over to a zone. They came out in man-to-man early, and I think they're really trying to protect the basket. And their position inside has worked for them the last few possessions.
Shot clock is off and 13 seconds to go in the first for Astoria. Benesh bringing it along the near side. Takes a screen right. Gets it ahead of the key. Guarded by Joe Janney. Trying to spin around at the free throw line. Kicks it near side to Huber, who steps into a triple. Back iron, no good. And the rebound will be collected by Astoria. Not enough time for a shot. And we head to the second quarter in a low-scoring affair. 10-8. The Hornets lead the Fishermen at the OSAA On Point Community Credit Union 4A Boys Basketball Playoffs on 104.3 and 960 Sports and MyBasin.com.
places where unconditional love and immeasurable happiness reside. This is home. Coldwell Banker, where home begins.
Back inside the Hornets' nest for the OSAA On Point Community Credit Union 4A Boys Basketball Playoffs. The Hornets lead after one, 10-8, and they start with the ball. Here's Aiden Hayes, kicking it to Chris Janney. Over to Bennett for a wing three that rattles home. 13-8, Henley leads after that Bennett triple. That gives him 6 points on the afternoon. Here's Benesh with it on the far side, guarded by Aiden Hayes. Benesh terminates the dribble, zips it down to Olsen. Olsen kicks it to Williams in the near corner. Cross-court pass to Benesh. Corner three for Merrick Benesh, no good. Collects his own miss, gets the defenders to jump, and he finishes a tough bucket close to the rim.
Good offensive rebound. Astoria hasn't had many of those.
Here's Aiden Hayes on the far side. His team up 13-10, 7-11 to go in the second quarter. Joe Janney has it stripped away by Astoria. It's Winterstein with the steal. Throwing it ahead to Huber, back to Benesh. Benesh guarded by Hayes. Kicks it far side to Williams for a triple, too strong. And McCready with the miss. Aiden Hayes walking it across the timeline for Henley. They like to slow the game down as they meet the Astoria zone. Here's Bennett. Bennett has it picked away for a moment, but recollects by Huber. Now to Janney. Janney back to Bennett. Now back to Janney. Janney able to drive the left block, tries to get it to Hayes, tipped out of bounds by Astoria. And the Hornets maintain possession. A couple of subs coming in. We'll see Owen Harper check in for Joe Janney. And for Astoria, Walker Steele in for Beck Olson. McCready inbounds it to Chris Janney, tries to get it back underneath to McCready, but he can't corral the pass. Out of bounds it goes, and the Fishermen take over.
Had the right idea there, just a little careless pass. I like how Henley's trying to get the ball to McCready, but not necessarily to score. He can attract people, dish it back outside.
Benesh trying to cross half court, finally gets rid of it to Huber. Huber finds its way down to Gore, close to the rim, and a whistle. I think they're going to get Janney for a foul, and Gore will earn two free throws.
That time it was Astoria's turn to break the press with some good passing. Really good passing down the floor. And they found a wide open player under the basket.
As the title sponsor of the OSAA State Championships, On Point does everything it can to help our team and community get ahead. On Point delivers the local banking and lending its members need to reach their goals and make more possible. Visit onpointcu.com. All right, couple of misses for Astoria. One make for Astoria at the line. 13-11 the score. Henley leads with 6:15 to go in the second quarter. Bennett fires another left-wing triple. It's good. Luke Bennett back-to-back made threes. Give him 9 points on the afternoon. His team a five-point advantage with 6:05 to go in the second. All right, here's Benesh now on the near side. Benesh trying to go to work against Hayes. Kicks it over to Huber. Huber down low to Moore at the free throw line. Pops and knocks a shot down. Benton Moore, the senior with his first bucket of the afternoon. And Henley leads now 16-13. Bennett thought about another three-pointer. Dumps it down low to McCready, battling for the shot and gets fouled.
That was a good offensive move that time from Marcus. He kind of shuffled to the inside. He made a good, strong move to the basket, and he'll be shooting two free throws.
McCready 2-for-2 already at the line. This is his third look, and it's good. And a substitution in for Astoria. We're going to see Olsen come back in. Benton Moore head to the bench. McCready's second free throw is also good. So the Henley Hornets lead 18-13 with 5:40 to go in the second quarter. Williams kicks it to Benesh. Benesh driving inside. Gets inside the paint and scores. Benesh with 6 points. It's now 18-15. Henley leads, 5.5 to go in the second quarter. Here's Aiden Hayes throwing it to Chris Janney. Janney to Bennett. Bennett, head of the key, back to Janney. Janney trying to drive left a little bit, gets it back to Bennett. Thought about a three, now back to Janney. Dumps it down low to Harper at the baseline, zips it back to Bennett. Bennett fields a bit of a double team and has the ball knocked away for a moment, but Chris Janney recollects. 11 to shoot for the Hornets. Harper driving baseline, tries to use the glass and it falls. Harper, 4 points for him today. His team up by 5 with 5 minutes to go in the second quarter. Here's Williams on the far side. Williams going to work against Bennett. Throws it to Benesch on the right wing. Dumps it down low to Olsen. Olsen tries to find Benesch cutting to the rim, but the pass offline and the Hornets take it away. Here's Bennett now into the front court for Henley. Turns on the Jets, driving to the rim, fading away. The jumper no good. McCready with the rebound. His putback won't go, and he's fouled.
Good second chance effort for Henley there. Astoria hasn't had many second chance points at all. Henley's really dominated the rebounding on that end. And most of Astoria's points are coming from the drive toward the basket. Not much outside shooting.
Henley does have a lot of good rebounders. We mentioned McCready averaging about 12.5, but you've also got Harper, who averages about 6 boards per game. Even Luke Bennett, one of their guards, averages just under 5 rebounds per game.
So that's really helped them so far.
Well, McCready makes his second of 2, and timeout is called. Henley leads 21-15. 4:35 to go in the second quarter. This is the OSAA On Point Community Credit Union 4A Boys Basketball Playoffs on MyBasin.com.
What rhymes with great?
Participate.
Where does greatness start? Here, in the classroom. On the stage.
In the pool.
On the field.
Where will your greatness take you?
To better grades.
To more friends. Yeah!
Be great.
Participate! Yeah.
About 4.5 to go in the second quarter. 21-15, Henley leads. Want to welcome in all the folks listening from Astoria, Oregon tonight on MyBasin.com. You're able to watch this game because of the Henley Booster Club helping us cover the rights fee to get on the air today. So thank you again to the Henley Booster Club, and welcome in all the folks rooting for Astoria today. Appreciate having you. They start with the ball. Here's Beck Olsen driving baseline, dumps it off to Benesch for a left elbow jumper. Hits the back of the rim and doesn't fall. Henley with the rebound and kick it ahead to Aiden Hayes. Hayes fires it over to Janney. Janney on the left wing, dumps it to Harper. Harper driving baseline, throws it out to Aiden Hayes for a near corner three, no good. Harper with the rebound, dumps it down low to Hayes. And Hayes, an errant pass, will create an over and back. And athletic play from Owen Harper to try to keep that possession alive on a couple of different occasions, but ultimately no points for the Hornets.
That was just unfortunate. That pass kind of floated high into the backcourt. And Astoria will take over here.
Cannon Huber to inbound. Throws it to Benesch coming off a screen in the far corner. Tries to hit a three-pointer, but the ball goes out of bounds on the rebound. And Henley takes over. 4 minutes to go in the first half. The Hornets lead 21-15. Aiden Hayes calling out the play is gathered by head coach Luke Hammond. Bennett kicks it to Janney near corner, fires it back to Bennett on the left wing, gets it down low to Marcus. Marcus is not going to miss those three-footers. He converts there.
Good pass from the outside from Bennett on the money.
23-15, Henley in front. Here's Beck Olsen throwing it ahead now over to Williams in the far corner. Williams driving against Bennett. Throws it into the corner for Olsen. Drives inside the paint. A nice step to the rim, but too strong on the layup. Putback is no good by Gore. And finally, McCready with the rebound. Henley takes it. Here's Aiden Hayes. Good work on the glass for Henley. And here's Aiden handing it to Bennett. Bennett driving inside. Kicks it out to Janney. Janney finds Bennett coming off a screen. Another left wing look for Bennett. That one won't go. Rebound goes out of bounds. Henley's run that same action with Bennett on the off-ball screen a few times.
Yeah, he's hit two threes. That time came up just a little long on the shot.
All right, racing into the front court is Huber. Ball finds its way over to Williams. Dumps it down low to Benesch. Kicks it out to Huber for a triple. No good. Rebound is collected by Olsen in the corner. Tosses it to Williams, head of the key, driving inside. A floater from 12 too short. And Harper with the rebound. Throwing it ahead to Janney. Janney along the right wing. Finds Hayes, head of the key. Dumps it down low to Marcus. Marcus going to work inside the paint. Strong move to the rim. Too strong on the layup, though. Ball goes out of bounds. Last touched by McCready. Takes some contact. No whistle. Now got to get back on defense.
I have a feeling Astoria is a better shooting team than we're seeing tonight. They're struggling a little bit from the outside, and that could change in a hurry. but they're going to keep shooting that ball.
Huber with it now, kicks it over to Williams. Now top of the key to Olsen. Uncontested three for Beck. Olsen is wide left. Henley another rebound. Here's Aiden Hayes. Hayes gets it to Bennett. Another left wing look for Bennett, but he dumps it down low to Harper for a fadeaway left block jumper that's good.
Good motion on the offense. Henley really cutting away from the ball very well.
Banesh has it now. About half court for Astoria. His team trails by 10 with under 2 minutes to go in the second quarter. Banesh takes a screen right, and they're going to call a reach-in foul against Janney. Trying to guard Banesh, who's the leading scorer for the Fishermen this year. 19 and a half points. He is the co-player of the year out of the Coapa League. 6 points today for Merrick Banesh. He'll be the one to, no, pardon me, it'll actually be Olsen, the one to inbound. Finds Owen Williams. Astoria trying to find a good look. Williams bounces around, kicks it out to Olsen. His triple again won't go. Gore with the rebound. His putback is no good. And Henley with the rebound. Janney throwing it ahead to Bennett. Bennett trying to split the defender and gets fouled on the drive. So that'll be the third Astoria team foul. Henley's at two right now. A minute and a half to go in the second. Henley up 25-15.
These are good defensive teams. Only five fouls combined this half. They play good defense. Don't give up all that many points.
Aiden Hayes collects the inbound pass in the backcourt. Now trying to get past Huber. Huber knocks it away from him, but Hayes recollects. Hayes dumping it down low to McCready in the paint. Uses the window and scores.
Good finish right there from Marcus off the glass.
Williams now brings it up for Astoria. Their team trailing by 12. A minute left to go in the second quarter. Here's Banesh. Driving left, terminates the dribble, dishes it to Huber. Huber back out to Williams, spinning around to his right, going to work against Bennett, off the glass, and it falls. Good move by Williams.
Good spin move. Through an easy hoop for the Fisherman.
Here's Hayes, into the front court for Henley, thought about going right, drives left, all the way to the rim. His shot rejected by Williams. McCready collected the rebound, has it ripped away, and Olsen got fouled trying to collect the loose ball.
That was a wild sequence right there. That just shows you the kind of effort we're seeing from these kids. There are bodies everywhere on the floor.
A lot on the line for these teams. Henley trying to make it back to the Elite Eight. They made it last year and finished fifth at the tournament. Astoria, they haven't made the tournament since 2016. Coming in as the 10 seed against Henley, the 7 seed. Here we go. Here's Astoria. Olsen handing it over to Gore. Gore well beyond the arc. At half court, and they're going to get him for a backcourt violation. It must have been his shoelace that crossed half court, but that's good enough at a backcourt violation.
And that was Bryson Montag with the defense there.
And it looks like we're going to have timeout called by Astoria with 22 seconds to go in the second quarter. We'll take it too. 27-17, this is the OSAA On Point Community Credit Union 4A Boys Basketball Playoffs on MyBasin.com.
Thanks to Les Schwab Tires, I'm a confident backseat driver, but Mom's a little stressed about spending. Remember, deep breaths and watch your speed. Even though we're watching our wallets, Les Schwab is still watching out for our safety. So it's right here.
During the Les Schwab Founders Celebration Sale, save up to $150 instantly on select sets of four tires. Les Schwab Tires, doing the right thing since 1952.
Back with you for the OSAA On Point Community Credit Union 4A Boys Basketball Playoffs in the Sweet 16. Henley leads Astoria 27-17 in the final seconds of the second quarter. 10 to go. Here's Hayes trying to throw it to Frank, but it's picked away by Astoria. Huber is going to step out of bounds collecting the loose ball, and Henley gifted a second life with 6 seconds to go in the second quarter.
That was another near miss, another deflection from that Astoria defense.
Lane Frank throws it ahead to Harper. 5 to shoot. Harper driving inside at the free throw line. Kicks it out to Aiden Hayes. He shoots from the elbow. He gets hacked. No whistle at the buzzer. And the Hornets might have been looking for that call regardless. They lead by 10 going to the locker rooms. We'll be back with some halftime stats and a look at the teams that have already made it to the Elite Eight tournament. That's coming up next as we continue your coverage of the OSAA On Point Community Credit Union 4A Boys Basketball Playoffs on 104.3 and 960 Sports and MyBasin.com.
Humble and not corporate. At Clownfall Subaru, we built our business on that simple promise. Well, that and some of the best people you're ever going to meet. Hi, I'm Rob Cedar, General Manager at Clownfall Subaru. Our 62 employees make it easy for us to live up to our comfortable, not corporate philosophy. Friendly faces, easy answers, straight talk, fairness, and exceptional service. These are the things you expect. These are the things that all of our people deliver. Our management team, sales pros, certified service and body shop techs, lot attendants, and detail experts are all 100% focused on you. Local people putting their friends and neighbors first. At Clown Falls Subaru, that's the only way we do business. It's comfortable, not corporate. Our team members also spend hundreds of hours each year supporting local charities and events through the Subaru Love Promise. That's the kind of people they are. We're very proud of them. They're your friends, they're your neighbors, they're glad to know you, and they want you to be glad to know them too. I'm Rob, and this is what makes us comfortable, not corporate.
It was kind of what defined me as a person. I loved to play every sport I could possibly play. The Abbeys was really the family stomping ground for all of our community. Saturday afternoon soccer tournaments, we'd head over to Abbeys afterwards. And then when we got up into middle school, on our way home, we'd stop at Abbeys after basketball games. When I go home, I want to see two things when I drive through Winston. I want to see my Abbeys, and I want to see my high school. And those are the two memories that stick out the most to me.
It's halftime at the OSAA On Point Community Credit Union 4A Boys Basketball Playoffs on 104.3 and 960 Sports and MyBasin.com. At halftime, Henley leads Astoria 27-17. And after 16 minutes, it's Marcus McCready, who leads all scorers with 11 points. Luke Bennett also on the Hornets with 9, 6 from Owen Harper, and 2 for Bryson Montag. Tally us up to 27 for Henley. For Astoria, 8 points for Owen Williams, 6 for Merrick Benesh, 2 for Benton Moore, and 1 for Quinn Gore. Gets us to 17 for Astoria. And Henley playing the kind of basketball that I'm sure they want to. Is the third best defense in the state. They've held Astoria well below their first half averages this season. They're playing good ball.
Yeah, Henley's defense really playing well. I feel like they're executing their game plan pretty well. I like their balanced scoring. Marcus is the leading scorer, but he's not getting the majority of the points. They're doing well on the outside also. And I feel like Astoria's just having one of those road game tough luck. There's like a lid on the rim. They just can't get those jumpers to fall. And I admire how they, if they're open, they're going to take that shot. And I'm sure they're going to keep shooting. I have a feeling some of those will start to fall. But Henley's defense is very good. They're contesting those shots, and they're making it tough for Astoria to score.
No doubt, this is a team that likes to shoot the basketball, and it's one of the top offenses in the state. 67 points per game for Astoria. They've only been held under their total, they've only been held to about 50 points three times this season, which is what Henley averages giving up. Meantime, Henley, they've only given up 67 points, which is Astoria's season average, one time, and it was to Junction City, who, by the way, the winner of this game goes up to play at Forest Grove. So Henley is a solid defense. Again, we mentioned third best defense in the state behind Seaside and Baker, a couple of teams who made the playoffs as well. We'll take a look at the Elite Eight. As we know, 7 teams have already made it and booked their ticket to Forest Grove High School in this year's tournament. The winner here will be the 8th and final team to try to make that trip to Forest Grove and claim a state championship. Taking a look at the bracket on the other side, this is the OSAA On Point Community Credit Union 4A Boys Basketball Playoffs, 104.3 and 960 Sports and MyBasin.com.
So lonely, I just sigh and mourn. Seems like I've been away forever, wondering if you're
This is where unconditional love and immeasurable happiness reside. This is home. Coldwell Banker, where home begins.
It's halftime at the OSAA On Point Community Credit Union 4A Boys Basketball Playoffs, coming to you live from Henley High School, just a few minutes south of downtown Klamath Falls, inside what they call the Hornet's Nest. Henley certainly plays well at home, and they find themselves up by 10 right now against Astoria. Winner here makes it to the Elite Eight tournament. Henley trying to get back there for the second consecutive season. Astoria trying to punch their ticket for the first time since 2016. We know that they'll play Junction City in the quarterfinals at the tournament. Let's take a look now at how the bracket's shaken out so far. Again, Junction City defeated Scappoose last night 60-31. As we move up the bracket from the right side, Marist beat Phoenix 59-30, and Crook County, the 14 seed, upsetting number 3 Seaside 46-37. So the Cowboys will be playing the Spartans up at the tournament. As we move to the left side of the bracket, Cascade beat LeGrand 77-37. The Cougars will meet Madras, who beat North Marion 84-70. Moving down, Philomath defeating Marshfield 49-37. That's the 5 seed beating the 12 seed. They'll play Baker, one of the top offenses in the state, who beat Newport 60-52. Again, the winner here is the final team that is trying to get to Forest Grove High School for the Elite Eight tournament. Both the Henley girls already punched their ticket today after they beat St. Helens to the tune of 71-48. Kevin Petrick, an assistant coach for the girls basketball team. You guys excited to make that trip again this year?
So excited. And, you know, it's hard to get there. And anybody who's coached or played or followed their kids, you can't take it for granted that you make it to Forest Grove for the state tournament. And we're very excited about the opportunity to go back this week.
Always a blast at the state tournament. Yeah. That means that we'll be there because the Henley girls are there. So if you want to follow at least the Lady Hornets, you could do so on 104.3 and 960 Sports. They get at least 2 games up there at the tournament. The boys trying to get there as well will, of course, have coverage again on this station, 104.3 and 960 Sports. Want to give a big shout-out to the Henley Boosters, who allowed us to get on the air on the video side of things this afternoon as we move into the playoffs. Got to pay a rights fee to the OSAA to make sure that we can bring this to you for free instead of a pay-per-view system, and that's what we want to do, make it free for those of you watching around the state and especially back in Astoria who understandably didn't want to make the long trip to the Klamath Basin. So that's all thanks to the Henley Boosters allowing us to get on the air today. So big, big thank you to them. And appreciate everyone who's joining us around the state and in Astoria. On mybasin.com, my name is Josh Eldridge. Kevin Petrick along with me this afternoon. We're going to take one more break on the halftime show. When we come back, it's third quarter action from Henley High School. Right now, the Hornets lead 27-17. This is the OSAA On Point Community Credit Union 4A Boys Basketball Playoffs on 104.3 and 960 Sports and mybasin.com.
Threads. There are many threads that run through our region. There are churches and schools and little league teams that bring us together and bind us into communities. There are roads and cars. There are houses and jobs and businesses, all woven together to make the fabric of our communities. There are financial threads that are part of that tapestry as well. For over 80 years, it's been our pleasure to be headquartered here, providing financial services to generations of our friends and neighbors. From that first savings account to retirement planning and all of the cars and houses and groceries in between, we keep your money local, investing it back into our communities, adding more threads to the fabric to make our community stronger. Pacific Crest Federal Credit Union. Find your path.
Welcome back. The OSAA On Point Community Credit Union 4A Boys Basketball Playoffs on 104.3 and 960 Sports and MyBasin.com. Just about ready for the third quarter of action from inside the Hornet's Nest at Henley High School. The Astoria Fishermen, the visitors tonight, they trail by 10, 27-17. You know, they kind of switched, like you'd mentioned, from a man-to-man look to more of a zone defense. It's allowed them to deny the ball to Marcus a little bit more inside, but it's left guys like Luke Bennett open along the perimeter in that second quarter.
Yeah, and the outside players for Henley are coming through, and that's why they have this 10-point lead. I really think it's going to come down to scoring opportunities in this half.
Astoria just has very few second chances. Henley's been very good on the offensive and defensive boards. I think the team that gets the most chances is going to end up winning this game.
It'll be Astoria who starts with the ball. They'll get the first chance here in the third quarter. Five on the floor for them, the same five gentlemen who started the game. Quinn Gore, Owen Williams, Beck Olson, Benton Moore, and Merrick Benesh. It's Gore with it now as the Astoria fishermen go from left to right. Here's Benesh going to work against Janney, spinning around the paint, kicking it outside to Gore. Gore driving right down Main Street, has his shot rejected by McCready. And now here come the Hornets on the other side. Aiden Hayes bringing it to the front court. Zipping it near side to Janney, to Bennett, head of the key, spinning around to his left. His shot from 13 is good. A tough bucket from Bennett gives him 11 points in the game. His team up by 12, 29-17. Here's Benesh. Benesh kicking it out near side to Olson for a triple to answer. No good. Benesh with the rebound. Benesh going to hand it out to Moore. He tries his luck from three. No good. Rebound is collected by Aiden Hayes. Now throwing it ahead to Chris Janney. Hornets have numbers, but don't hit the gas too hard. Here's Janney now getting it to Hayes. Hayes back to Janney on the right wing. Astoria coming out once again in a zone look. Here's Bennett now on the left wing. Bennett guarded closely. Get it to Harper. Driving baseline. Goes up with the shot and is fouled. Harper headed the line for a pair.
Owen likes that move. He'll just walk that tightrope on that baseline and flip the ball up around the rim. And he'll either score it or draw a foul. That time, here in two free throws.
On Point Community Credit Union is a proud sponsor of the OSAA State Championship. On Point is Oregon's largest locally headquartered credit union, serving more than 539,000 members. Visit onpointcu.com. You mentioned Owen Harper. He's made a huge leap in play this season. As he started at the beginning of the year, I think Harper was still trying to kind of find his role within the team. But through league play, he averaged 8 points per game and six rebounds, coupled with two assists. He's found a nice role in this team.
Yeah, playing a lot of confidence.
Harper goes one of two at the line. Benesh bodies his way to the rim and can't score. Score remains 31-17. And Henley in front, Harper kicking it outside to Bennett, left all alone for a wing triple, cash money for Luke Bennett.
Luke shooting the ball very well today.
Hornets doubling up Astoria here in this playoff round, 34-17. Again, the fishermen can't score. Frustration from Williams as he misses the layup. On the other side, though, it's taken away. Williams all alone to the rim and scores that time in an uncontested layup. 34-19, 6:09 to go in the third quarter. Henley in front of Astoria. Hayes throwing it over to Janney. Janney to Bennett, head of the key. Bennett thought about throwing it left. Now gets it to Janney on the right side. Back to Bennett. Bennett guarded by Williams. Now to Janney. Janney finding Harper. Back to Janney. Hornets taking their time. Throwing across the court to Hayes. Dumping it down low to McCready. Fields a double team. Trying to spin to the rim. Takes a lot of contact and has the ball taken away from him. Now into the front court to Astoria. It's Olson who fires a triple splash. And a whistle. We're going to see Astoria take time with 5.5 to go in the third quarter. We'll take it to 34-22. The Hornets in front. This is the OSAA On Point Community Credit Union 4A Boys Basketball Playoffs on MyBasin.com.
Thanks to Les Schwab Tires, I'm a confident backseat driver, but mom's a little stressed about spending. Remember, deep breaths and watch your speed. Even though we're watching our wallets, Les Schwab is still watching out for our safety. So turn here.
During the Les Schwab Founders Celebration Sale, save up to $150 instantly on select sets of four tires. Les Schwab Tires, doing the right thing since 1952.
Hornets start with the ball coming out of the break, and Astoria showing a little bit of a press on defense as they trail by 12, 34-22. Here's Aiden Hayes with it, getting it to Marcus into the front court, head of the key for McCready. Throws it over to Janney, dumps it down low to Harper on the left block. Back out to Janney, now to McCready. McCready is swarmed by Fisherman, goes up with the shot and scores. McCready with 13 points, his team leads 36-22. Here's Benesh. Benesh guarded by Bennett, top of the key. Benesh gets rid of it, now finds its way over to Williams, who steps into a triple, leaves it short. Rebound collected by Huber. His mid-range shot is also offline. Astoria gets another look. Here's Williams in the near corner for three. That one finally finds its way home for Williams.
They've got a couple three balls in a row trying to find their way back in this game.
That's the way this team stayed in the game last year, and they create a steal going to the rim. Huber too strong on the layup, but he's fouled. Huber going to the line for two, and we talked about it. These two teams met last year in this round. It was a close, slim victory for Henley, 65-62. And it was the three-point shooting for Astoria that allowed him to hang around. And a three-point heave to try to tie the game by Benesh was just a hair offline last year. And now they find themselves trying to battle back into this game. Chance to cut the lead back down to 10.
Yeah, on that last possession, if you remember, they got two offensive rebounds.
Yep.
And a team that shoots like this, you just if they get more chances, they're going to start making those shots. And that's just what they need to do.
Huber missed the first free throw. Here's his second. And that one falls. So a 10-point game, 36-26, 4:42 to go in the third quarter. Here's Aiden Hayes. Hayes faced with the Astoria zone. Now here's Bennett. Bennett trying to get it to Janney, but it's taken away by Benesh. Throws it ahead to Williams, and his layup is too strong once more. They're trying to ask for goaltending, no whistle. Here's Aiden Hayes, racing up the floor, goes to the cup, and he's fouled hard. Aiden Hayes earning two free throws.
Yeah, there's quite a discussion going on down there on the Astoria bench with the officials. And the team captains are also asking why that wasn't a goaltend. That rim was shaking pretty hard down there.
Yeah. Well, I'm not even sure that the ball was touched on that shot.
Well, I think if you manipulate or move the backboard of the rim in any way, grab the net or slap the backboard, that is a goaltend.
Okay, yeah, that makes sense.
So you can't be shaking that rim. So
here's Aiden Hayes at the free throw line. It's good. The first shot is.
Meanwhile, Henley did a nice job of staying focused, brushed the ball down the floor, and then got themselves in a shooting situation here. So good heads-up play by the Hornets.
Aiden Hayes' second free throw is on the way, and it rims out. Astoria with the rebound. Score remains 37-26, 4:15 to go in the third quarter. Here's Gore bringing it along the far side, getting it to Williams. Quick trigger three, no good. Harper with the rebound. Here's Aiden Hayes bringing it into the front court. Hayes going to hand it off to Bennett. Bennett switches to his left, goes between his legs, loses the dribble for a moment, but recollects. Now here's Lane Frank. He thought about a three, tries to get it to Hayes, but it's picked away by Olsen. All alone to the cup, and he scores. Astoria's gotten aggressive in the passing lanes. They find themselves only trailing now by nine. Here's Lane Frank, bouncing it over to Bennett. Bennett gets it down to McCready, throws it to Frank in the near corner. Frank for three, no good. Rebound is going to roll out of bounds as a whistle is called.
That was a good call down there.
Harper got shoved pretty good.
Beck Olsen actually had his arm around him, gave him a big old hug down there, and he got caught. That happens sometimes.
McCready to inbound to the baseline. Lofts it high to Hayes, but it's taken, or tipped rather. Loose ball collected by Frank. Frank trapped at half court, tries to get rid of it, but it's taken away by Astoria. Bounce pass intended for Williams is going to go out of bounds. A miscue by the fisherman costs him a turnover.
You know, in the first half, we saw Astoria tip a lot of those passes. I think they're being a little more aggressive. They're anticipating a little better, and they're actually coming up with some steals here in the third quarter.
Timeout called, 3:19 to go in the third quarter. 37-28, the Hornets lead the fishermen. This is the OSAA On Point Community Credit Union 4A Boys Basketball Playoffs on MyBasin.com.
Sports was kind of what defined me as a person. I loved to play every sport I could possibly play. The Abbeys was really the family stomping ground for all of our community. Saturday afternoon soccer tournaments, we'd head over to Abbeys afterwards. And then when we got up into middle school, on our way home, we'd stop at Abbeys after basketball games. When I go home, I want to see two things when I drive through Winston. I want to see my Abbeys, and I want to see my high school. And those are the two memories that stick out the most to me.
Welcome back to Henley High School in the OSAA On Point Community Credit Union 4A Boys Basketball Playoffs. The Hornets of Henley High School lead the Fishermen of Astoria High School 37-28, 3:19 to go in the third quarter. The winner makes it to the quarterfinals. which will take place on Thursday at Forest Grove High School. Thursday, Friday, Saturday, these teams trying to make that tournament. Here are the Hornets. Aiden Hayes bringing it up the floor. Kicking it over to Luke Bennett. Luke Bennett on the right wing. Finds Frank, top of the key, bouncing it over to Hayes in the near corner. Hayes, ball high above his head, kicks it to Bennett. Bennett terminates the dribble, dumps it down low to McCready, kicks it outside to Frank. He fires a right wing triple that finds its way home.
Good inside-out play. Marcus finds a guard, hit the three.
Astoria trying to answer quickly on the other side. It's Benesh on the left wing. Benesh takes a screen right. Now dribbles it back out against Bennett. One-on-one, bounces it near side to Williams. Williams takes a screen left, kicks it back to Benesh, still beyond the arc on the right side. Go to work against Frank. Frank locking down Benesh. He has to get rid of it to Gore. Gore driving inside, up with the shot, too strong off the glass. The Henley student section erupts in cheer as their team leads by 12. 40-28, 2.5 to go in the third. Frank, a pass intended for him, is taken away by Williams. He takes it to the rim and scores. Williams has had a nice third quarter. He's up to 7 points in this frame. His team trails by 10. 40-30, 2 minutes to go in the third quarter. Here's Lane Frank. Frank throwing it to Harper in the far corner. Now back to Frank. Frank driving along the right side, kicks it back outside to Bennett. Bennett fielding a double team, kicks it over to Frank. His three-point shot denied by Olsen. Now here come the Fishermen. Pass comes to the near side for Williams. Quick trigger three, good. That's Williams' second triple of the quarter. Give him 10 points in this quarter. His team now only down by 7. 40-33, 1:35 to go in the third quarter. Hayes takes his time, crossing half court. 25 to shoot for the Hornets. Here's Frank with it now on the far side. Frank driving in, trying to go to work against the defense. He's tied up. A held ball. Possession's going to stay with the Hornets.
Astoria's defense very impressive these last three or four game minutes. They played very well. They've cut that lead to 7.
Here's Bennett to inbound. Tries to find Hayes cutting to the rim. The ball batted out. They're going to call a foul. This one's going against Frank. He tried to dive for the loose ball. Ended up kind of undercutting the Astoria player.
Yeah, Henley needs to take a little bit better care of the basketball here. Astoria's really taking advantage of some turnovers and some easy transition hoops. They can cut it to 5 or less here.
All right. Here's Benesh. Benesh, top of the key, kicking it over to Huber. Huber inside. Now outside to Williams. Another triple for Williams. That one's no good. Here's Frank, trying to push the pace a bit for the Hornets, kicking it ahead to Bennett. Bennett trying to drive the baseline. Up with the shot. The left hand is no good. McCready down low is fouled on the putback.
Marcus, such a strong rebounder, not only with his size, but he has good skills and instincts. That time he knew right where the ball was going to fall, and he was able to pick up the rebound.
McCready at the line for 2 free throws. Dear style, efficiency, and performance, glad we're on the same team. This season and every season, let's keep huddling up and going for it. Toyota, let's go places. McCready's first free throw, no good. He gets a second one. And Marcus's free throw clanks off the right side of the rim. Benesh with the rebound. Astoria feeling a little bit of momentum. Here they come. Benesh denies the right side screen, driving right down Main Street. He gets fouled, but they're going to say that the foul was before the shot. And Janney's going to pick up that foul. Joe Janney, that's his first and the team's third. And Gore at the baseline to inbound. It's going to find its way over to Olsen, who fires a quick triple, no good, and Harper skies for the rebound.
He really did leap that time. Good vertical there.
Here's Hayes, now into the front court for Henley. Kicks it over to Bennett. Bennett thought about a three, trying to find McCready down low, and does on the left block. Marcus driving to the rim, misses the first shot, collects his own rebound, and has it stripped. Huber with the takeaway. Shot clock is off, 30 to go in the third quarter. Here's Benesh. Benesh takes a screen left, backs up, has McCready isolated, but Joe Janney switches onto him. Janney's done a good job of guarding Benesh tonight. 17 to go. Here's Benesh trying to take a screen left, and they're going to call an illegal screen on Beck Olsen.
Good defensive possession for Henley there. And And they'll get the last shot here in the quarter.
14 seconds. Henley trying to get some shooters onto the floor as Frank checks in for Janney. So the five out there for Henley. It's Hayes, Frank, Bennett, Harper, and McCready. Here's Hayes. Crossing the timeline, 10 to shoot. Hayes throws it to Frank. Frank finding Bennett on the far side. Bennett dumping it down low to Harper at the baseline. Outside to Frank. Catch and shoot. Three for Frank. No good. And that'll bring us to the end of the third quarter. Henley, 8 minutes away from another trip to Forest Grove High School. The Fishermen still trying to come back. It's 40-33. This is the OSAA On Point Community Credit Union 4A Boys Basketball Playoffs on MyBasin.com.
Wait. All I do is wait. So lonely, I just sigh and mourn. Seems like I've been waiting forever. Wondering if you're coming home.
I just saw your face. I know you're coming home. I swear there is no place that feels as good as home. And then I heard your voice. I know you're coming home.
This is where unconditional love and immeasurable happiness reside. This is home. Coldwell Banker, where home begins.
Fourth quarter action lays ahead at the OSAA On Point Community Credit Union 4A Boys Basketball Playoffs on 104.3 and 960 Sports and MyBasin.com. The Fishermen start with the ball trailing by seven. Make it five after a nice mid-range jumper from Owen Williams. 12 points in the second half. He had eight in the first, trying to will his team back into this game. 40-35, 7:40 to go in the fourth quarter. Here's Bennett now on the far side for Henley. Gets it to Chris Janney. Chris Janney gets it back to Bennett, steps into a triple. Bennett bangs it home.
He is lights out shooting tonight, or today, either one.
43-35, 7.5 to go in the fourth quarter. Here's Benesh. Benesh takes a screen right, steps back, tries to answer with a triple, rolls off the rim. And Bennett with the rebound. He's going to get it ahead to Hayes. Yeah, Luke Bennett has got 8 points and two made triples in the second half. Give him 17 for the game. Harper with it now in the far corner to Chris Janney. Janney throwing it over to Harper, trying to drive that baseline. Kicks it out near corner to Hayes. Pump fakes a three. Gets past the defender. Outside to Harper. Near corner three for Owen. Harper's left short. Benesh with the rebound. Benesh tossing it ahead to Williams. Williams trying to go to the rim and gets fouled. Tough collision down low between Aiden Hayes, Marcus McCready, and Owen Williams, and it earns Williams a couple of free throws.
That was a good aggressive move to the basket by Williams. You know, there's always a lot of talk in these games about, you know, obviously the story's at sea level, and they come up right all the way here, and it's a little bit harder to catch your breath, get some air up here. Astoria looks fit. They don't look like they're having any real issues with their fitness today, so they're able to run with Henley so far.
And for those of you listening from Astoria, we're about 4,100 feet here at Henley High School, so that's a pretty big jump.
We have seen teams come up and struggle with that.
Yeah.
But Astoria doesn't seem to be.
The first free throw was no good. The second one hangs on the rim and falls. And so one for two, trip to the line for Owen Williams. 43-36, Henley leads. 6:45 to go for the season. Here's Aiden Hayes getting it to Bennett. Bennett, top of the key. Throws it right side to Janney. Back to Bennett. Coming off a screen. Dumps it down low to McCready. The mismatch down low. McCready kisses it off the glass and scores.
Marcus gives his guards a big target. Makes it easy for them to find him. Easy hoop.
45-36. Here's Astoria. Williams coming off a screen. Now head of the key. Spins to his right. Kicks it outside to Gore. Gore steps left. Drives right. Nice finger roll. Layup is too strong. Rebound collected by Aiden Hayes. Here's Hayes walking into the front court, throws it to Harper. Harper now to Bennett in the near corner. Bennett driving baseline, kicks it outside to Aiden Hayes, zips it to Janney, down low to McCready, on the right block, throws one off the glass, no good. And it's Benesh with the rebound. Benesh tossing it ahead to Williams, steps into a triple, no good. Rebound collected by Janney, now to Hayes. Hayes guarded by Williams, gets rid of it to Bennett. Bennett puts it on the deck, terminates the dribble, finds Janney. Janney cutting to the rim, splitting up the defense. Too strong on the layup, but Harper is there for the tip-in.
Using his jumping ability again. Good tip-in.
47-36, Henley leads, 5:20 to go in the ball game. Astoria with it. Benton finds its way over to Williams. He tries his luck for a corner three. Right through the twine. And 47-39 the score, 5:05 to go in the fourth. Here's Hayes. Hayes handing it to Bennett. Now to Janney. Off to Bennett on the right side. Bennett, ball high above his head, finds Harper for a shot from about 18 feet out, and Harper curls that one off the rim and in.
Henley showing good patience on that possession. That was a perfect possession for Henley.
10-point lead for the Hornets, and we've got time. 49-39, 4:45 to go in the fourth. The OSAA On Point Community Credit Union 4A Boys Basketball Playoffs on MyBasin.com.
What rhymes with great?
Participate.
Where does greatness start? Here, in the classroom. On the stage.
In the pool.
On the field.
Where will your greatness take you?
To better grades.
To more friends.
Yeah!
Be great.
Participate!
Yeah! 10-point game, 49-39 in the OSAA On Point Community Credit Union 4A Boys Basketball Playoffs on MyBasin.com. Thanks again to the Henley Booster Club for helping us get on the air today, at least for the free video aspect of things, allowing everybody from around the state and Astoria to watch and listen. Thanks again to the Henley Booster Club. 4:45 to go in the ball game and a 10-point lead for the Hornets. Here are the Fishermen. With it now is Huber. Huber tries to find Williams, his three again offline. Rebound collected by Astoria. Underhand dish outside to Huber. Top of the key three, too strong. And this time the rebound ripped away by Chris Janney. Tough board, but collected by the Hornets. Janney throws it over to Hayes. Hayes, cross court pass to Bennett. Left wing three for Luke is no good. And the rebound collected by Olsen. Olsen shoving it ahead to Huber. Driving baseline, terminates the dribble, kicks it back out to Olsen. Now to Williams, tries his luck again from three, and again a miss for Olsen. Or pardon me, Williams. And now Henley again, trying to buy themselves a little time as we cross the 4-minute mark to go in the fourth quarter. And a whistle as Hayes crossed half court. Williams making contact with him there. That'll be his second foul.
Astoria is intentionally showing some urgency here. Offensively, they're putting the ball up in a hurry, and it makes sense. 4 minutes to go in your season, you're down 10, so look for them to be more aggressive on both sides of the floor.
Here's Aiden Hayes, getting it near side to Bennett. Bennett thought about a triple. Harper was open on the baseline, but they get it to McCready, and the ball taken away by Astoria. They try to speed up the floor. Here's Huber against McCready, and McCready's going to foul Huber, trying to block the shot. Two free throws coming up for Huber.
You know, by watching the flow of the second half, you'd think Astoria maybe has the edge on Henley a little bit, but Henley led at 10 at half, and they lead at 10 right now. So you look at the big picture, Henley's doing a good job of not letting them get too close, and playing just good enough defense to keep their lead.
Trimmed down to a 9-point lead after that make from Huber, who was an all-conference honorable mention. Probably for his defense, averaging about 5 points per game this season, but he's played good defense today. Second free throw missed, and Astoria collects the rebound. Williams left alone, lane to the rim is denied by McCready. Ball is kicked out to Olsen. He tries his luck from three and cashes in. Olsen's second made triple gives him 8 points on the day. His team only trails now by six with 3.5 to go in the fourth quarter. Pass to the front court to McCready. McCready kicks it to Janney. Janney getting by the defender, kicking it out to Harper. Harper driving to the rim, up with the shot. He gets fouled, and he's earning a couple of free throws. Willow and Harper.
They may have called that on the floor, Josh. It looks like. Ooh. They'll be taking this out under the basket.
Well, that was the third team foul for Astoria. Inbound pass to McCready. McCready contested shot, no good. And here comes Astoria. Benesh bringing it up the floor. Benesh takes a screen left, gets around the defender, kicks it outside for a triple. That's no good. Benesh with the rebound, though. getting by the defender, goes to the rim, again no good, and this time McCready cleans it up before getting fouled. A bit of emotion coming out for Marcus as he collects the foul.
Yeah, that was an important rebound right there, and Marcus knew it. Henley hanging on to a six-point lead here, just under 3 minutes. Henley's going to want to take a little more time off the clock here. Be more patient. They're very good when they pass the ball multiple times, five, six, seven times, get those cutters moving, and then score with an easy basket. That's what they should look to do here.
Are they we're having a conversation with one of our officials, Craig Connor, and Quinn Gore, that looks like Connor's walking him off the floor. I just don't think he checked in. So here we go. All right. Five on the floor for Henley. It's Owen Harper, Aiden Hayes, Marcus McCready, Luke Bennett, and Chris Janney. And for Astoria, it's Williams, Huber, Gore, and Moore. Hayes trying to drive to the rim. Took some contact. No whistle. And a whistle on the loose ball. I believe they're going to whistle Harper for the loose ball foul. And the last guy I missed was Beck Olson out there for Astoria.
So Astoria will be shooting free throws on the next foul. That may come into play here.
Gore dribbles it along the left side, gets it to Williams coming off the screen for a quick three, and he splashes it. Three-point lead for Henley starting to get tight with 2.5 to go in the fourth. Pass into the front court to McCready, gets it ahead to Bennett. Bennett along the far side, dishes it to Harper, back outside the perimeter, now to McCready on the right elbow. Back outside to Bennett. Bennett dribbling past the defender, gets it to McCready, one step to the rim, McCready's fouled, and he's earned free throws.
That was some good offensive work from Henley, making a few passes, finding Marcus inside. Josh, you mentioned it earlier, this game is sizing up to be just like the one we saw last year, right down the stretch.
Henley the first team to 50 after a made free throw there. Yeah, last year these two teams met in this round. It was a 65-62 win for Henley. And McCready, a couple of made free throws, extends their lead now to 5. 51-46, 2:15 to go in the final quarter. Here's Gore. Gore to Williams. Williams crossing up Janney, driving to the rim. Strong layup is good from Williams. He's a tenacious player. Trims this thing back down to 3. Here's Aiden Hayes. Hayes guarded by Williams, throwing it to Marcus. Marcus beyond the arc, throwing it to Bennett now. Bennett finds Harper on the baseline. Back to Bennett. Bennett now along the left wing. Feels a little bit of pressure, gets rid of it to Harper. 15 to shoot now for the Hornets. Here's Bennett. Bennett spins around the defender. Now gets it to McCready, and McCready is going to be whistled before the shot as he gets fouled on the floor. But I believe that's the fifth Astoria team foul anyway, so McCready heading back to the line.
Marcus had strong hands on that one. That ball was kind of up for grabs, but he just willed it his way.
That's also going to mark the end of the night for Benton Moore, the senior, heading to the bench. He scored 2 points tonight. He's going to have to rely on his team to extend his high school career.
I misspoke earlier. Henley does have one more foul to give before Astoria shoots. They have 3.
McCready's first free throw, no good. He's earned quite a few trips to the line tonight. His second free throw, also no good. Big misses at the line for Marcus. Gives Astoria a breath of life with 1.5 minutes to go in the fourth quarter, trailing by 3. Here's Gore. Gore throwing it over to Olsen, but it's picked away by Hayes. Hayes to the rim and gets fouled. Created a lot of contact to get to the line.
He did. That was a great play. He moved his body, used it as a shield, and basically forced that defender to foul him. Good work on that fast break.
By the way, that's also Beck Olsen's game over as well. He's fouled out, and he exits the game with 8 points. That senior now trying to rely on his team to extend the season. We're seeing the first of Teague Palmberg tonight, who's checking into the game for the Fishermen.
That was a huge play from Aiden.
Aiden can't make his first free throw. That's 3 consecutive misses at the line for the Hornets in crunch time. Here's Hayes again. That one no good, but Harper there for the putback, and this crowd explodes. Gives his team a 2-possession lead. 5 points, 1:19 to go in the game. Williams trying to direct traffic a little bit for his team. Comes off a screen left, spins around to his right. Free throw line jumper. Williams somehow finds the bottom of the bucket.
He's had a great half. 3-point lead for the Hornets.
To cross the 60-second mark, here's Hayes. Hayes over to Bennett. Bennett over to Harper in the corner. Harper gets it back to Bennett. Head of the key, 20 to shoot for the Hornets, 51 on the game clock. Pass finds its way to Harper. Harper now to Janney in the near side. Janney zips it to Hayes in the near corner. Cross-court pass to Bennett. Bennett alone in the corner, picked up by the defense. Now driving inside, stops at the right elbow. Tries to throw it up off the rim, no good, but it resets the shot clock. Hayes driving to the rim, and the foul for Aiden Hayes.
What a series of events. I don't think that was his shot. I think he was trying to pass the ball, wasn't he?
He was. It hit the rim and reset the shot clock.
It did. It hit the rim, got a funny bounce, and Henley ends up with it.
Free throw is good. A six-point lead for the Hornets. 34 seconds to go. Astoria is going to work quickly. And a timeout. We're going to have to wait for them to work quickly until after this pause. 31 seconds to go in the ballgame, and Henley up by six. This is the OSAA On Point Community Credit Union 4A Boys Basketball Playoffs on MyBasin.com.
Sports was kind of what defined me as a person. I loved to play every sport I could possibly play. The Abbeys was really the family stomping ground for all of our community. Saturday afternoon soccer tournaments, we'd head over to Abbeys afterwards. And then when we got up into middle school, on our way home, we'd stop at Abbeys after basketball games. When I go home, I want to see two things when I drive through Winston. I want to see my Abbeys, and I want to see my high school. And those are the two memories that stick out the most to me.
Two-possession game and less than the shot clock to go for the Astoria Fishermen. Their season on the line. They're going to have to operate quickly and probably create a foul. Now, a little bit of time for Astoria to be picky about who they foul. But, again, their season on the line, going to take a lot of composure for these young men to extend this game.
Yeah, they're going to have to do the old-fashioned extend the game here. Be quick on offense, foul, and hope for some missed free throws on defense.
Owen Williams to inbound, 56-50, the Hornets in front. 31 seconds to go, they inbound to Quinn Gore. Gore brings it into the front court. Henley trying to trap him at the perimeter, getting rid of it to Williams. Catch and shoot three for Williams. Good, my goodness, he can't miss. Now inbound to Bennett. Bennett's going to get it back to Harper. Astoria waiting to foul. Now back to Bennett. Still a three-point lead, 13 to go. The ball is stripped away, but a whistle. And this one is going to go against Astoria and should earn Bennett some free throws.
Astoria trying to kind of play half and half. They're trying to get the steal. They might get the steal, get the ball without fouling, and they almost did there.
I think they left themselves a decent amount of time left as well, 11 and a half.
That's a good strategy. Try to get that steal if you can without fouling, and if you have to foul to stop the clock, then you need to do that.
Bennett's had a good game tonight, except for at the free throw line, just one of three so far. Here's two more opportunities. First one. Keeps everyone in suspense, ricochets out and then back in. Back up to a four-point game. He's made it. Two possessions. And the second one also rolls around the rim and drops. 58-53, Astoria having to work quickly, 10 seconds to go. A three-point shot offline from Huber and a foul. That'll send Aiden Hayes to the line. The Hornets can begin to taste Forest Grove High School.
Henley in that last minute really played well. Some clutch baskets, some clutch rebounds. They took care of the ball at the end. Really played well when they needed to at the end of this ball game.
Hayes at the line for two, misses the first. And we're going to have a timeout called by Coach Hammond. We'll stick with you through this one at the OSAA On Point Community Credit Union 4A Boys Basketball Playoffs. You've had it on MyBasin.com, 104.3 and 960 Sports. If things stay where they are, 4.5 seconds to go and Henley up by five. We'll follow the Hornets to Forest Grove High School as they try to battle for a state championship. You can always catch them on 104.3 and 960 Sports. Unfortunately, no live video at the state tournament. That's all pay-per-view on the NFHS Network, but it's still an option for you. And it looks like they're just going to send Hayes to the line. The rest of the Hornets are going to play defense, it seems, and back out to about half court. They've got McCready stationed right above the arc on the other side of the floor. Here's Hayes' free throw. It is good. 59-53. Astoria, here's Gore. Gore fires up almost a half-court shot. It's no good, and the Henley Hornets are going to the Elite Eight at Forest Grove High School after taking care of business 59-53 against the Astoria Fishermen, whose season is over. We'll try to recap it all for you, give you the leading scorers, plus an outlook at what's coming up next for the Hornets. This is the OSAA On Point Community Credit Union 4A Boys Basketball Playoffs on 104.3 and 960 Sports and MyBasin.com.
Wait, all I do is wait. So lonely, I just sigh and mourn. Seems like I've been away forever. Wondering if you're coming home.
This is where unconditional love and immeasurable happiness reside. This is home. Coldwell Banker, where home begins.
Introduce Smith Bates Marcom Solutions, your trusted partner in marketing and communication. We specialize in crafting compelling campaigns, eye-catching graphics, and impactful branding materials.
Smith Bates is like working with dependable friends. They always help us build our professional image.
Through the innovative strategies that the team at Smith Bates suggested, we've been able to give the brand at Calor the boost that it desperately needed.
Unlock your potential with Smith Bates Marcom Solutions.
Final score from Henley High School, 59-53. The Hornets are going to the Elite Eight at Forest Grove High School. This is the OSAA On Point Community Credit Union 4A Boys Basketball Playoffs. We've got some unofficial scorers for you tonight. Leading the Hornets in scoring tonight, Luke Bennett with 19 points. 17 for Marcus McCready, 14 from Owen Harper, 4 from Aiden Hayes, 3 from Lane Frank, and 2 from Bryson Montag. For Astoria, 31 points from Owen Williams in his final game with the Fishermen. He also got 8 from Beck Olson, 6 from Merrick Benesh, 2 from Benton Moore, and 1 from Cannon Huber and Quinn Gore. Get you to 53 for the Fishermen. The Hornets, they played a good game of basketball tonight. They survive, and they're moving on.
Yeah, Henley with a well-deserved win. That defense was great. You know, I can't believe Astoria only had 17 at half.
Yeah.
I mean, everything that Astoria was having trouble with in the first half, they corrected in the second half, and they really, really played well. But I admire Henley. Henley just, they just stuck to what they know how to do. They played good defense. They rebounded when they needed to. And they played good in the clutch. So two even teams. We knew it was going to be even coming into this game. And Henley pulled out the 6-point win, going to Forest Grove again. Really exciting for the Henley community.
How about Luke Bennett and Owen Harper? You know, I've kind of talked all season about how the guard play has improved for Henley all year. I mean, you got a 6-7 post. You can feed him all game long, and McCready's going to get his points. But I mean, the guard play has improved enough for Bennett to lead his team in scoring tonight. Was deadly from beyond the arc, 19 points, 14 for Harper. He cuts to the rim really nicely. This was just a good all-around performance by Henley's kind of secondary players.
You're right, Josh, right on the money. I mean, these other coaches in the state, they see the film. They watch. They know Marcus is big and he's good inside. And the improvement of those perimeter players for Henley makes all the difference. They've had a great run since the first of the year. And you're right, they're not the same team we saw in December. They'll be a formidable foe at the state tournament.
Well, we know who they're going to play, and we'll tell you on the other side as we take a look at the updated bracket, the OSAA On Point Community Credit Union 4A Boys Basketball Playoffs. It's been brought to you by the Henley Booster Club on MyBasin.com.
Comfortable and not corporate. At Clownful Subaru, we built our business on that simple promise. Well, that and some of the best people you're ever going to meet. Hi, I'm Rob Cedar, General Manager at Clownful Subaru. Our 62 employees make it easy for us to live up to our comfortable, not corporate philosophy. Friendly faces, easy answers, straight talk, fairness, and exceptional service. These are the things you expect. These are the things that all of our people deliver. Our management team, sales pros, certified service and body shop techs, lot attendants, and detail experts are all 100% focused on you, local people putting their friends and neighbors first. At Clownfall Subaru, that's the only way we do business. It's comfortable, not corporate. Our team members also spend hundreds of hours each year supporting local charities and events through the Subaru Love Promise. That's the kind of people they are. We're very proud of them. They're your friends, they're your neighbors, they're glad to know you, and they want you to be glad to know them too. I'm Rob, and this is what makes us comfortable, not corporate.
Back with you at Henley High School, the OSAA On Point Community Credit Union 4A Boys Basketball Playoffs on 104.3 and 960 Sports and MyBasin.com. The Henley Hornets defeating the Astoria Fishermen 59-53. Take a quick look now at how the bracket looks. This was the only game we were waiting for to find out who's going to Forest Grove High School. The Hornets are going to play Junction City, who beat Scappoose 60-31 last night. The two seed there, Junction City, a good squad. Also making the tournament, Marist Catholic will play Crook County. By the way, the Cowboys upset Seaside as the 14 seed, 46-37. So congratulations to them making the tournament. We're going to see Baker play Philomath. Madras is meeting Cascade. Those are your Elite Eight teams heading to Forest Grove High School. That tournament begins on Thursday. And as the Hornets progress through the tournament, the Lady Hornets as well, you'll be able to hear them every tournament game on 104.3 and 960 Sports. Be sure you keep your eyes on OSAA.org, by the way, because as it stands right now and as the brackets worked out, both the Lady Hornets and the boys are projected to play the late game, but in years past, the OSAA has kind of moved those games around so that way, well, we can cover both games for you. And if you plan on going to the tournament, you can watch both games. By the way, if you are planning on going to the tournament, the OSAA has gone digital with Hometown Ticketing. They're the official ticketing partner of the OSAA. You can access tickets to all state tournament events through the OSAA website or OSAA Live app. Be sure you purchase your tickets in advance. You can also get them at the gate as long as you scan that QR code. Visit osaa.org/tickets and get those tickets as the Hornets are going to Forest Grove High School. That game is going to be played on Thursday night. Again, keep your eyes on our website to find out when exactly that'll be because it is subject to change. Once again, the final score tonight was 59-53. Want to tip the cap to a couple of the Astoria kids who've finished up their high school career as seniors. Owen Williams, who was, fantastic tonight. 31 points for the senior there. Also, Andrew Winterstein, Beck Olson, Teague Palmberg, Benton Moore, and Merrick Benesh all playing their final games with the Fishermen. A great high school career and a good season for Astoria, but they just ran into the Hornets in Klamath Falls again, and their season is over. Henley has improved to 16-7, and again, they are going on to the tournament. Astoria finishes the season at 18-7 as well. Before we wrap things up, any final thoughts before we let you get out of here, Kevin?
No, I'm just going to say it was it's really fun when both the boys and the girls programs get to go to the state tournament. Henley brings a great community up. We were able to do it last year. It'll be fun again this year. So really looking forward to that. I also want to mention real quick the My Basin guys, Josh, Matt, Rob, Beckett, you know, the community. I'm out in the community a lot. We really appreciate your hard work. We see it. We know how hard you guys work. You guys, with all the games, your coverage this year has been terrific. It stepped up every year you've been doing this. And so it's been my pleasure to join you guys in some broadcasts. But the community really appreciates the work and the effort you guys put toward the athletics that you cover.
Well, thank you. It's always a joy. And tonight we're able to make it possible. Thanks again to the Henley Boosters who allowed us to get on the video stream. All of you who've been watching here in the Basin and in Astoria and St. Helens, if you've been with us this whole time and all around the state, you've been able to watch this because of the Henley Booster Club. They were able to help us cover the rights fee to get on the air this afternoon. So it really is a community effort, Kevin. You know, I broadcast a lot of different schools. I don't think I've ever gotten the support anywhere else that I have at Henley High School.
Yeah, it's great.
So it's a great time and a great time to be a Hornet as they are heading to the state tournament again on Thursday. You'll be able to listen to that on 104.3 and 960 Sports. If you want to watch any Henley basketball this season, you can do it on MyBasin.com. We've got replays of the games, and also everything else going on in the Basin is on MyBasin.com. News, sports, special events, everything else on MyBasin.com. Once again, the final score tonight, the Hornets advance to the Elite Eight to defeat Astoria 59-53. For Matt Bowling and Kevin Petrick, my name is Josh Eldred saying so long and see you later.